This is 1430 ESPN, WBEV AM, Beaver Dam, a Good Karma Brands hometown station.
1430 ESPN's Friday Night Lights, presented by Cousin Subs of Beaver Dam, continues with Beaver Dam High School football.
Here comes Bryant, rolling to his right, going to heave it into the end zone. Caught, touchdown, Golden Beavers! Sliding through on the backside, the Moose, Brandon Morrissey. And a great way to end the opening drive of the season. Rosenthal's going to throw, heaves it long up over the middle, and it's intercepted by Boston Damon at the 50-yard line. In a motion, Glatt out of the backfield. Empty backfield screen on the near side to Keel. Got to cut it back up the middle. What a move by Kyler. Cuts it back to the inside. Threw a couple of defenders into the end zone. Touchdown, Golden Beavers. 25 yards, Bryant to Keel. They're up 33-0. Third and 10, Vittingall out of the shotgun. Here comes the pressure again. And down he goes, Cameron Mendoza with the sack around the left side. Hand off to Klatt, who's going to break it to the outside. There goes Gabe. Gabe breaks a tackle. Gabe Klatt is off to the races. 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Golden Beavers. 78 yards to the house.
Tonight's game is presented by Columbus Family Dental, Hometown Glass and Improvement, and the Beaver Dam Unified School District. It's also brought to you by these community-minded partners.
Cousin Subs of Beaver Dam, the Park Village Shopping Center, Jerry's Automotive,
McKinstry's Home Furnishings, Kladowski Real Estate, Silica for your home,
Summit Ford, Preferred Dental Partners, Beaver Dam and Mayville Tire and Service,
Shorefire, Richards Insurance, Slumberland of Beaver Dam and Watertown,
Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Air Care, The Dump in Cambria.
Let's head to the field. Here are the voices of the Golden Beavers, Wade Bates and Tim.
And good evening, everybody, from Slinger High School. We have reached the second season of Beaver Dam High School football on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN. I am Wade Bates, along with Tim Ladron and Justin Wilski. An old Wisconsin Little 10 matchup here in the first round of the Division II playoffs. Beaver Dam and Slinger, coach, two teams that are really excited to see each other.
Yeah, like you said, it's two teams that have, you know, seen each other a lot over the past years, over the Wisconsin Little 10 and everything else, and you know, it's a great place to play. We're talking about off the air. The atmosphere here is awesome. Every time you come here, it's a beautiful turf field. It's a beautiful night for football, and can't be more excited when you're in the playoffs.
And we already know the winner of this one's going to have a home game next week, because number one seed Milwaukee King got beat by eighth seeded Germantown 15-9 earlier today. So the winner's going to be at home.
Yeah, and what a great opportunity for either one of these two teams to not just, if they can win tonight, and then get a home game in advance past level two and get to level three and really make some noise to the state, to Camp Randall.
Coach, Slinger's a team we're going to see tonight. They were picked to win the North Shore Conference by Travis Wilson at WisSports.net. Ended up losing a few games and finished third in the league. But they're a quality team that's big up front.
Well, it's a really tough conference. A tough loss to Homestead early in the season, and a three-point loss ended up being kind of the de facto conference championship, losing to them early on. But it's a team that's battled some injuries, and they got a couple they're dealing with tonight. But they're up front. They're very, very good. I think you could probably put them along the lines of Wanakee and what we saw last week when you talk about that up front. And they're a team that scores a lot of points, 279 points on the year as compared to Beaver Dam's 212, a team that can really put some points on the board.
And Beaver Dam, I think one of the number one word to describe the Golden Beavers this year, coach, is resiliency, because they've had a lot of it this year. They faced a lot of adversity, and they've always just found a way.
Yeah, and so you feel like, you know, if they can keep this thing tight, and I think it's got a chance to be a really tight football game. If it gets to a fourth quarter football game, you got to feel really good about Beaver Dam, because they've survived so many of those throughout the year.
Well, we are making progress, but there remains a shortage of licensed officials for a number of high school sports in Wisconsin and nationwide. We owe a debt of gratitude to those who have committed their time and efforts to ensure that we're able to sustain education-based athletics. Because without officials, there are no games. If you have what it takes to make the right call, please don't hesitate. The exciting and rewarding experience is calling on you. Let's get you licensed as a contest official. It's also a great way to earn more than a few dollars. Access officials tab at the WIAA website, wiaawi.org, to get started. A message from Daily Dodge TV, 1430 ESPN, and the WIAA, keeping education in sports. When the Daily Dodge pregame show continues, we are going to hear from Golden Beaver head coach Brock Lindy. It is Beaver Dam and Slinger, the Division II playoffs on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
Are you ready for peace of mind? Chad Guzzi here, owner of Air Care and Beaver Dam. If you're tired of unexpected repair bills, you want to sign up for our Total Care plan. It ensures top performance and prolonged life of your heating and air conditioning equipment. Air Care's Total Care customers receive annual inspections as well as a reduced maintenance rate plus a 10% discount on all service repairs. Air Care, big enough to serve you, small enough to care, 920-356-8860.
The teams at Beaver Dam and Mayville Tire and Service are growing and adding service technicians and auto lube technicians. Work in a clean shop environment with a fun and friendly team that is committed to excellence and customer satisfaction. Competitive pay based on experience, full benefits, including health, dental, 401k. Join the growing team at Beaver Dam and Mayville Tire and Service. Find full job postings on Facebook or visit either location to submit your resume.
Hi, this is Dr. Adam Forster at Columbus Family Dental. If you've been unhappy with your smile, it's time that you come and see us. Our team of doctors are waiting to help you get your smile back. We'll take the time to talk with you and treat you like a member of our family, not just another number. Whether it's a whole mouth makeover or simply a little tweak, we'll find the right solution that fits you. For your free, no-pressure consultation, call us today at 623-5559.
The fun doesn't stop when the game clock hits zero. Celebrate your team's sweet victory at the Dump Bar and Grill in Cambria and tackle some mouth-watering appetizers, award-winning juicy burgers, or some crispy wings. The Dump Bar and Grill has it all. And with their newest Annex Edition, enjoy more seating for all fans to gather. Satisfy your hunger and get to the Dump Bar and Grill in Cambria, your go-to spot for great food and good times. TheDumpBar.com, cheering on all our local student-athletes.
Cheer! Now cheer louder. Any accomplishment worth doing with all your heart and soul. The entire team at Hometown Glass and Improvement knows that dedication, time, and respect can lead to greatness. When practicing free throws, running for a touchdown, or installing new windows and doors, it's a commitment to something larger than oneself that creates a legacy. So keep cheering for your hometown team. Hometown Glass and Improvement, online at hometownglass.com.
Join the American Packaging team and help create packaging for some of the most iconic brands in the world. Sarah says the benefits at American Packaging are fantastic.
At American Packaging, we have a great 401k match. They match us 75 cents for every dollar up to 5%. And we get quarterly bonuses if we meet our budget. We get a Christmas bonus. If you've been here 5 years, you will also get a seniority bonus.
Learn more about joining the American Packaging team in Columbus and DeForest by checking out the careers page at AmericanPackaging.com.
Jerry's Automotive in Beaver Dam is a champion of our local schools. Team up with Jerry's Automotive by pumping your gas at their Spirit Pump, where 2 cents of every gallon is donated to a local school each month. Jerry's Automotive also provides exceptional vehicle service and repairs and a great selection of convenience items. Visit Jerry's Automotive Center, WI.com, and on Facebook. Jerry's Automotive, 700 North Spring Street in Beaver Dam, across the street from Beaver Dam Food Pride.
Is selling your home like a walk in the park? If you are in Central Park at 2 a.m., maybe. Chris Kladowski, Kladowski Real Estate. When it is time to sell, be it due to loss or love, growth or downsizing, staying near or going far, there are 3 basic steps. List it, sell it, move on. The steps are made simple by working with a trusted real estate advisor. Our family team is with you every step of the way, making those 3 steps as smooth and fun as possible. Kladowski Real Estate. We look forward to serving you.
You're watching the Daily Dodge pregame show.
Let's bring in Beaver Dam High School football coach Brock Lindy as his squad getting ready for their Division II Level 1 playoff game at Slinger. Coach, when your name came up as a number 5 seed going on the road to Slinger on Saturday morning, just see your thoughts on when you saw your opponent.
Yeah, we're just really excited to be in the playoffs and to celebrate a really successful year. Kind of a bounce back year with a lot of things that went wrong last year. Kids have put in a ton of work and we've kind of improve some of the areas that caused us to miss out last year. So, although we would have preferred a home game and wanted to get as good of a seat as we possibly have gotten, we're excited to play close-ish to home in Slinger, and a 4-5 matchup is a better matchup than we've had in our last couple playoff runs. Yeah, so cool. we stay away from a 1 or a 2 seed, and it's anybody's game on Friday.
You know, we found you never quite know when the computers are going to spit out those numbers the last couple of years, but did you kind of think you'd probably be in that 4 or 5 seed range, trying to wait till that 10 o'clock in the morning slot when the seedings came out?
It was hard to determine even kind of what region we were going to go into, because we could go into one of probably 3 of the 4 regions that exist. And then you start looking at teams and looking at conference opponents and figuring out who's probably a 1 or a 2. And we figured we were probably a 3, 4, or 5 seed. And then it was just a matter of, who we'd draw. So not really surprised by anything, and could have certainly done some things to help our cause a little bit more throughout the year. But I feel like that's water under the bridge at this point, and now we're just going to play 1-0 football this week.
Coach, yeah, I just have to be proud of you mentioned, fixing some things maybe that were issues last year. I know a game of inches, I guess you can say, and that was the case, the 2022 season. This year, you have to be proud, and we've talked about it a lot in pregame shows and postgame shows, just the resiliency of your team and the fight that they've shown, whether they've been down and they've been found ways to rally to get back into games and ways to rally to win games. You have to be happy with just the intestinal fortitude that your team has showed this year on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, our kids are battlers for sure, and we kind of find ourselves in the same situation this year as last year with probably our best offensive player and defensive player missing significant time. But I think that shows the growth of the program and the growth of the players. And in a year, we've been able to go from 0-4 in one score games to 4-1 in one score games. And it would have been great to be not in one score games. It would have been great to be 5-0 in one score games. But the reality is that to make that kind of shift from one year to another is 100% a credit to our players and the work that they've put in. And the buy-in to the belief and vision of what we expect to do with this program on an annual basis.
Coach, going to Slinger on Friday night, looking at Slinger, they were, North Shore Conference, middle of the pack team. They were 4-3, but they played Homestead to a close game. Just when you look at film, just tell me what you see from the Owls.
Yeah, offensively, they're pretty balanced. They're massive up front. So it'll be noticeable in the trenches that we're the undersized team, but we can use some things to our advantage, and the bigger team doesn't always win. So we've got to be sound fundamentally. We've got to make sure that we're reading keys and trying to learn from the 2 films that we have from them and put ourselves in a good defensive game plan that tries to limit their balanced attack. Defensively, they're a 4-4. And play with some of those similar massive offensive linemen on the defensive side. So it's not reinventing ourselves on either side of the ball. And we want to do what got us here and what we feel comfortable doing. At the same time, we feel like there's things on both sides of the ball and in special teams that we're going to try to capitalize on. And it's been a fun rivalry with them over the years when we were in the Little 10. And we had very competitive games with them back then, so I would expect nothing else on Friday.
Coach, looking at their quarterback, he's thrown for almost 1,300 yards, 17 touchdowns, just 3 picks. I mean, what type of thrower is he? He looks like he takes care of the football.
Yeah, very efficient. Kind of a dual threat kid. They'll get him involved in the run game. Left-hander who throws on time and has good pocket presence. So he kind of ranks up there as one of the top quarterbacks we've seen this year, but at the same time, our Badger Conference is absolutely stacked with quarterbacks. And so our D-backs, I think, are well-tested. Our linebackers have had to learn how to play both run and pass this year. And so we just got to try to get some rush on them and contain them and hold up on the back end like we've kind of done all year.
How about facing a lefty quarterback? I mean, you've seen them. Just you have to prepare differently, or the kids have to kind of have a different mindset knowing that things come from the opposite side?
Yeah, we just have to make sure that we bring pressure in his face. I think a lot of teams mistakenly bring pressure from the backside too much. And really it's that pressure in a quarterback's face that's going to make someone a little bit antsy. So Now we just need to kind of reevaluate where our pressure packages come from. And that's easier said than done with a big offensive line and a power run scheme that they have. So a lot of it comes down to our D-backs and making sure that they are sound in their coverage principles and you know what their responsibilities are. But we certainly know that our linebackers and our D-line can make their jobs a lot easier in the pass game.
Is there more juice in the locker room at practice when it's playoff week, Coach, or is it you try to keep it as just another week like a regular season game?
We try to be as consistent as possible, but Monday's practice was the best practice we've had all year. We have our full JV team there as well, and so we've got our JV guys running scout. We probably ran three times as many plays into our defense on Monday than we do in a normal week. So the volume was there, high energy. Kids are really excited about the opportunity to play. The seniors especially, to be able to extend their playing careers a little bit more. And now we're in win or go home, and that's cliche, obviously, but it's a little added pressure. It's a little added excitement, though, and we want to harness that pressure, and we want to harness that those nerves and use those to our advantage and getting us ready for a really competitive game.
Coach Brock Lindy, I appreciate the time, and we'll talk again on Friday night. Thank you so much.
You got it. Go Beavers.
Beaver Dam football Friday night on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
Hi, this is Sandy from McKinstry's Home Furnishings in downtown Beaver Dam. We are proud to support all Beaver Dam athletes. While at home watching high school sports, why not be comfortable? McKinstry's is a Lazy Boy comfort studio. We have sofas, recliners, sectionals, and reclining sofas. Stop into McKinstry's Home Furnishings in downtown Beaver Dam and add comfort to your home.
In today's financial markets, you will find all your needs met at Park Village Shopping Center. Time is right for a home equity line of credit. The folks at Horicon Bank can make those home remodel dreams a reality. Searching for sound financial advice? Kevin Smith of Edward Jones will help you make sense of your investments. Kevin knows the market inside and out. Knightberry Title meets all your title needs, from commercial to residential. The team at Knightberry is your partner for success. This is why you hear people say, "I shop Park Village Shopping Center." You should too.
Park Village Shopping Center.
You're watching the Daily Dodge pregame show.
And welcome back to Slinger High School. Wade Bates and Tim Ladron getting ready for Beaver Dam and Slinger. A little extracurriculars at the start of this one, Coach.
Yeah, and the Beaver Dam was getting ready for the anthem, and Slinger came out and got in a couple of the guys' faces and across the 50-yard line, and now a couple of the coaches are talking about it, and hey, Slinger's way over there on the wrong side of the field, and that's an interesting way to start. A little chest bumping, a little pushing and shoving from there.
All right, Wade Bates and Tim Ladron back here at Slinger High School, a level one playoff game here, Beaver Dam and Slinger. Thanks for coming on board with Justin Wilski, presented by Columbus Family Dental, Hometown Glass and Improvement, and the Beaver Dam Unified School District. Jack Wilski pushing the buttons back at the Global Media Center, and Ember Wilski here as well. And we are going to keep it right here to enjoy the national anthem. Tim, a couple of keys that you're looking for here in this one early.
Well, obviously we talked about up front, right? I mean, Slinger's huge up front. Beaver Dam's got to be able to hold their own on both sides up front. And as games like tonight always comes down to mistakes and turnovers, Beaver Dam's got to be really, really sharp with the ball tonight.
All right. Again, beautiful night for football here to open this thing up. And we're going to we'll keep it here for the national anthem. And, you know, I kind of feel bad because I didn't wear shorts today, Coach. All right, the national anthem is out, and we are set for football. For those of you on 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam, the Golden Beavers have the yellow pants, Coach. That's for Coach White, the gold pants. The white jerseys with the green numbers. Slingers in all red from head to toe here today. And turf field here at Slinger. Great athletic facility, great campus at Slinger.
I mean, it's beautiful. And, you know, they got the pep band going and packed house. We got a great, great, great traveled crew from Beaver Dam across the other way. It's a beautiful night for football.
Hey, if you are watching the broadcast, whether you're a fan of Beaver Dam or Slinger, send us an email, sports@dailydodge.com. That's sports@dailydodge.com. Tell us where you're from, who you're rooting for. But you have to put Beaver Dam or Slinger in the headline, because we also have Columbus and Broadhead Judah on Daily Dodge TV tonight. Tronson and Haldeman are over there getting a ton of emails as well. So we want to make sure I don't open up mics and somebody's saying, go Cardinals, and we're like, who are the Cardinals? Because they're both Cardinals on that in that game tonight.
You know, oh yeah, that's right. You know, we've got, I mean, we have two great games on. I mean, you expect both of those games, to our game here and the one over there, to be outstanding playoff football games. And boy, a lot of emotion, and it's exciting to get back into playoff football.
Becky Freund checking in from an airplane heading home from the Caymans, hoping to see a BD win when they get off the plane.
Nice.
Oh, and Wayne Freund just checked in from the Grand Cayman, so maybe Becky's going home and Wayne is still at the game.
Michael Kutsky, let's go. Send those owls packing. Go Beavers.
All right, Beaver Dam is going to receive here. Again, turf field at Slinger. I love their logo. Love the owls logo.
Yeah, I do too.
Good gear. End over end kick on the near side, and that's going to roll out of bounds. So the Beavers going to have good field position. Led out there by Eli Bryant. Thrown for 1,028 yards. Was Josiah Barnes at 681, seven touchdowns. Mendoza, 261 and a touchdown. Barnes has had a nice run here since Gabe has gone down.
Well, and that's the thing, right? Because, you know, Josiah's really only ran about half the season. He gets 681 through half the season. He's averaging 5.3 yards a carry. Cameron at 5.2 yards a carry. So doing a nice job on the ground, and Eli's been effective through the air.
This Slinger defense has got a handful of all-conference players from last season. Again, they're big and they're strong. Beaver's going to work off the near hash at the 35-yard line. They're going to motion Morrissey from right to left. Bryant out of the shotgun. Hand off to Barnes, the left side, and he is going to work his way across the 35 up to the 36. Maybe got a yard right there, and that's it.
It'll be interesting to see what kind of holes we can get against this big line from Slinger. And Coach Lindy mentioned in the pregame that they're going to play a 4-4, and they're going to in the crowd that box. Might see a little more from Eli Bryant through the air tonight, and a beautiful night to do it.
Work out of the shotgun. Mendoza heavy to the left. Barnes will dot the I. Play fake. Bryant's going to throw. Looking. Going to heave it on the right side for Keel, who makes the catch across the 50 at the 49-yard line. Flying out of bounds. And the Beavers move the chains for the first time today.
Yeah, great ball. A great route. He also had Morrissey over the middle. Eli had his choices there. Took Keel. Picked up the 14-yard gain.
Just underway here. Winner will have a home game next week as Germantown knocked off the top-seeded Milwaukee King 15-9 earlier today. A couple of wides to the far side, to the near side, another wide receiver. It's Jeff Freund. Bryant's going to throw again. Got some time. Now he's going to tuck it. He's going to heave it long up over the middle. There's lots of contact. It's incomplete as Bryant took a shot from behind. It'll be second down and 10.
Yeah, pretty good job by Eli to step up in the pocket, though, and get rid of it, and almost a bit of a throwaway there. Really smart play by Eli to hang on to that.
Hey, Ken Barrett checks in, cheering on from Illinois for number 55 for the Slinger Owls, the center, Nathan Hatterer. Slinger got the first check-in, Coach, after the Freunds. Who scheduled a trip to the Caymans when the playoff time goes? Jeffrey Freund makes the catch, and he's going to dive forward across the 40 near. He's only going to mark him just at the 40. It's going to be third and about one.
Well, and you see that, you know, that Beaver Dam is coming out and throwing a little bit with Bryant's third attempt of the night already in four plays, three passes, and a couple nice balls early and big third and one here.
11:13 left. First quarter, first drive of the game. Beavers moving to the right. Movement at the line of scrimmage and didn't get the whistle, so. Hand off to Barnes, and he is going to get to the line, and he's not going to get it. He ran right up the gut. Josiah was at the 40, and then he ran into a brick wall. One of the first guys, you know, a couple guys slid through, but I think that Caden Reiner was one of the guys that made contact.
First big decision of the night, fourth and one here for Beaver Dam. Looks like they're going to go for it.
Clock rolls. Fourth down and a full 1 yard. They got to get to the 39. Bryant will have three wides again. Power to the right. He's going to throw right side. Throw it up over the top of Jeffrey Freund, and Slinger gets the hold here on downs. A little high.
Nice quick route. Good decision. Just a little bit high for Jeff. Couldn't come up with it. Slinger's going to get the ball in good field position.
All right. This is where the Beavers are going to get tested. The front seven for Beaver Dam. I talk about Charlie Hoydink. Out there, he wears number 56. He is going to Stanford. He's 6'4", 304, but then Richard Garrick is a second-team all-conference player. Chase Jacklin last year was an all-conference player. That looks like a small college line out there, Coach.
Yeah, they're huge.
Mike Thede's thrown 17 touchdowns and just three picks. He's a southpaw, three wides to the right side. He's going to throw, angles one to the right side. It's going to get caught sliding to the turf over there, making the catch was Joey Micknick.
At the 46. And you mentioned Garrick over there at right tackle, 6'3", 340. Must be able to move his feet pretty well, too, as a tackle.
Ryan Gable checking into the broadcast with Bunchy tonight from Florida. Talked to Ryan on the way here today. He says, go Beavers. Second down and four from their own 46-yard line. Thede going to hand off right side, right up the middle. I think that's Burkle near the 50-yard line, and that's going to be enough for a first down.
Moves the chains for a Slinger Owls first down.
Yeah, just a quick little run up the middle, and, you know, Beaver Dam's going to have to do a really good job up front, because if they have to attack and put more into that box defensively, that's going to open up the field for Thede, who's a very capable quarterback.
First and 10 at the midfield stripe, a couple of wides to the far side, and Lytle and Micknick. Thede, handoff right side, straight up the gut. A big hole opened up down into Beaver Dam territory. Burkle going to gain about six on first down. John and Teresa Sharkey watching today. John got late mowing his lawn tonight, and he couldn't make it the trip, so he had to stay in. Teresa hopefully made her dinner, brought her dinner tonight, huh? She's probably disappointed that he was a little slow to the wheel on that thing today. Slinger moving to our right. No score. This level one, division two playoff matchup. Thede again, the quarterback sneak, and he is going to get brought down, sliding through everybody for the Golden Beavers. Jarek Westover.
Boy, and Westover's had a really good start to the season, or best back end of the season. He's kind of been all over the place on the defensive side.
Got another email we'll get to in a second here. It's going to be third down and three. Watching the game on YouTube, grandmother and Slinger fan of number 50, Jack Lockwood, says good luck to all. Thanks, Bonnie, for the email. Couple of wides to the near side. Third down, we'll call it three from the Golden Beaver 43-yard line. Slinger moving to our left. Thede's going to throw. Has a little bit of time. Tucks it now, and he's going to run and got some room. He's going to get the first down. Oh, he got
fumble. Him.
Fumble. The football is picked up by the Golden Beavers. At the 38-yard line, that thing came out, and the Beavers going to have it.
And it was Jarek Westover again. That's his fourth fumble he's forced this year. Big hit after the first down.
Remington Deals picked up the fumble, and Slinger is saying he was down, but you saw it when he went down. Thede put his head down trying to get across the chains, and the ball popped out.
Yeah, he certainly wasn't down. I saw the fumble right away when Westover popped him. He lost it immediately. That's a big play. Beaver Dam needed that, and a chance to put something on the board.
Work off the far hash at their own 38-yard line. No score on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN. Toss over to Barnes, and he's going to turn it upfield and get to the 41, maybe the 42.
Oh, they're only going to give him the 40. Pick up a two.
Gain of two on the play.
The ground game looks like it's going to be tough tonight. It looks like this is going to be probably Eli's most passing attempts on the year, is that front eight is really good.
He'll mark it at the 40. Bryant going to roll to the near side. Got some time. Steps up. Throws over the top. He's got his man wide open. Oh. Overshoots Jeffrey Freund, who there was had to have been a breakdown in the coverage because he had nobody within 10 yards of him.
Oh, man. He was wide open. That was a touchdown. And Eli was under some pressure. He got hit as he threw it. And that's a tough throw, rolling right all the way back to that left sideline. But, boy, that was an opportunity right there.
Slinger dodges a bullet right there because that was six.
That was six. It's hard to underthrow or overthrow Jeff, too, because he could fly.
I have a question. Why is, you know, we talked about Wayne Freund being at the Grand Caymans. Was he opening up like a bank account over there or something? What has he got going on? Because, you know, what have you been to the Grand Caymans for? He's watching, though. Bryant's going to throw again. Got some time. Throws it to the corner. Looking for Keel, and that's going to be out of his reach, and it'll be fourth down. Beavers had a chance there.
They did, and I think the positive of that one was it was the pass protection was pretty good there. You know, even the one where Eli missed Freund on the sideline, he got hit late, but he had time to let that play develop. And then he had some time on this one, too. So that might be a positive sign and let Eli settle into that pocket.
So the Beavers will have to punt. They're going to send back Mark Lytle, who was an all-conference first-team North Shore pick last year. 7:53 left here in this first quarter. No score. Freund didn't see him back. High kick. Lytle's going to call for the fair catch. He muffed it. It's on the ground. And then he tried to run with it after he called for the fair catch.
Yeah, they're just going to mark it right at the fair catch spot or where he muffed it. It'll be at the 25, 26-yard line here.
So that's where the Owls will start, first and 10. Because he did call for the fair catch, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Yep. Isn't that – try to run with it after you call
it. It's a penalty.
But I wonder if Beaver Dam might have gotten away there, too, with maybe a kick-catch interference. Yep. Aiden Root was pretty close there.
Jody Osterhaus checking in from Fondy. Go Beavers. My old stomping grounds. 7:44 left in the first quarter. Thede's working with two wides this time. Going to hand off, trying to break it to the outside. That's Burkle, and he's going to get tackled at the 28. Gain of maybe two. Another check in here. Erica and Russell saying, let's go Beavers, watching in Beaver Dam. Good luck tonight from the Holy Land. Tom and Deb, grandparents of the Freunds, are dominating the social media tonight. Man, they're checking in for what, blank supper club? Second down and eight. 7:10 left in the first quarter. Winner will host Germantown next Friday night. Rolling Thede rolls to his right, and he's going to complete it over there on the fly, caught by Lytle. That'll move the chains.
That's a tough pass for Thede. We had a left-handed quarterback rolling right and throwing a nice pass to the sideline there.
Kale Zomer says, nothing better on a fall Friday night than some high school football playoffs and eating hot wings at my house. Since there's heat in the booth, we don't need heat in the booth tonight, do we?
Oh, it's beautiful.
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 I'm upset I didn't wear shorts. First and 10. Thede, low snap, going to hand off to Burkle, who's going to go behind his big line. And look at that. He's just following big number 79 right there, Richard Garrick. I mean, he's a bulldozer, isn't he?
Well, and nice patience to know that you've got that big line to go behind, right? I mean, just a really nice patient run.
Hey, if anybody knows Dawn Carroll, send her a text right now. Ask her why she's sitting on the Slinger side, not on the Beaver Dam side, right below us.
Let her know she's on the wrong side of the field.
Yeah, can you please text Dawn Carroll and tell her that she's sitting on the wrong side of the field? Thede's going to keep it himself. Right up to me, he's got a big hole. He's got the 50 again. Dives forward down to about the 48-yard line, and that'll move the chains. Aiden Root on the tackle here with 6:18 left.
Corey Sparks just checked in on the YouTube.
Wants to know what the best Halloween candy is, Wayne. Corey Sparks wants to know what the best Halloween candy is? That's a blowout-type question. We're not going to have that tonight. I go with the Reese's.
Yeah.
No question.
Yeah.
I brought the jumbo.
That's an easy one.
I crushed eight of those the other day. I stopped at Walgreens, and they had them on sale, two for $5. My goal, I wanted to eat 100 Reese's, actually, during the morning show. Remember that, Ninja?
I do.
And my wife stopped me from doing it. I thought I could do it in 3 hours. First and 10, 5:46 left. Thede's going to throw near side. He's going to complete the Lytle again, and he's going to get brought down near the 40-yard line, gain of about 8. Yeah, that's my dream in life. He's 100 Reese's Peanut Butter Cups between 6 and 9 a.m. every morning.
Holy man.
I think I could do that's like 30, that's like 33 an hour.
Oh.
Whenever he double them up.
Like so. like the full ones?
Yeah. Yeah, not the smalls.
Not small. I mean, who smalls kind of wimp would do 100 smalls?
They'll mark it at the Beaver Dam 40 here. Slinger hustling back to the line of scrimmage. Thede working out of the shotgun. Handoff up the middle again. And another big run down inside the 35-yard line. Jack Klippel.
Again, it's really, they've got a couple nice backs, but really it's just fouling that big offensive line, just getting behind them and let them make a push. And they're doing that.
Go BD, bring home a win. The Ziegler girls checking in. Hope everything's fine in your neck of the woods. Steph Eastlick says go Beavers. Varsity manager Kylan Reynolds is watching from home tonight as well while she preps for a sectional race at Slinger tomorrow. Pitch to the right side, turning it upfield is Rodriguez, and he's going to cut it back. He's going to get stood up on first down, gain of a couple.
Rodriguez on the carry.
Cut that back, and the Beaver Dam D was right there.
Yeah, it's a seventh play of the drive, and you can see now Slinger's just trying to pose their will up front, and they've got a couple different backs doing it. They've had four different guys carry it already tonight. And you can see what their game plan is, just kind of pound away.
4:13 left in the first quarter, no score. Beaver Dam and Slinger on 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam, Daily Dodge TV. Three wides to the near side. Thede's going to throw a screen on the near side, threw it high, but it was caught by Lytle. Going to turn it back upfield, and he gets brought down in a hurry. And there's that guy again, Westover. Yeah.
You know, and that was set up pretty well. That little screen was set up pretty well. Beaver Dam collapsed on that nicely. They only pick up a 2-1.
Good luck, Beavers, from the Sextons, Eli Bryant's grandparents in Lake Mattoon, Illinois. Sports at DailyDodge.com. If you're a fan of the Owls or the Beavers, we want to hear from you.
Big play here on third and long. Beaver Dam's got a hold here.
Trips to the right side. Klippel stands to the left of Thede. Long count. Thede's going to throw. Looking, got some time. Here comes the pressure. Gavin Vitense, down he goes at the 38-yard line. Thede went down. It's going to be fourth and long, and here comes the kicking unit.
Gavin Vitense on the tackle.
It'll be a loss of 6, and Vitense's sixth sack of the year comes at a huge time. Slinger's going to punt this one away.
Boy, he made some big plays, Coach, all year down the stretch here in some games.
Look at this protection in the middle, the punt protection in the middle here at the 45. They have three big linemen up front to protect the punter. Oh, it's a
direct snap right there, and down goes number 74, a direct snap to a Cooper Williams on fourth and 15, Coach.
I don't know if that was going to be a pass, a rollout pass, but I mean, Cooper Williams, number 74, 6'1", 230-pound offensive lineman. I had mentioned they had three offensive linemen there up front. They snap it to him and try to get a fake punt. I can't believe it.
He was kind of following his lineman. Was there going to be a pitch to the back to the punter, and they were going to try to throw? But that wasn't fourth and three, Coach.
That was unbelievable. That's a great gift for Beaver Dam.
Beavers have it at the 44. Bryant's going to throw. Got some time. Heaves it over the middle, and he tried to thread the needle. And they're going to throw a late flag as Keel got drilled after the play right there by a Matthew Retzloff, and that's going to be a free 15.
I'll tell you what, the coaching staff is going to see that, and they're going to run that play later because Leo George, one-on-one on this near sideline, had beat his defender when it was open.
So the Beavers got a little momentum here with 2:29 left in the first quarter. No score. Slinger faithful aren't happy. It wasn't the hit. It was the shoulder. I think he kind of shouldered into him, Retzloff did.
Okay. I missed it after the incompletion because I was kind of looking at Leo. But it's a 15-yard penalty and a first down.
That'll put it into Slinger territory at the 41. And you know, if Eli gets some time, Coach, you're going to be able to throw the football tonight.
Yep.
Mendoza power to the left. Couple of wide receivers to the left as well. Going to hand off to Barnes, and he's going to break a tackle, get to the outside. Josiah turns it upfield and gets maybe the 35 down to the 34. Nice gain for Josiah around the outside.
They're going to give him, it's like the 33. So it's going to be a pickup of five, though. But that's his best pickup of the night, or pickup of four. I mean, it is certainly tough sledding on the ground.
Grandma Jan and Aunt Lena are watching from Stillwater, Oklahoma. Go Beavers. First snap, Mendoza gets his first carry. He's going to bull his way across the 35 down to about the 33. It's going to be third down. Have to watch the chain gang is very efficient, Coach. They flip that down marker before the play is over, so I got to make sure I don't get caught. We're going to go under 2 minutes left here in the first.
I think it's a good opportunity to take a shot. Third and two on the 32 here, or 33.
Barnes.
Take a deep shot.
George and Keel to the near side. Mendoza power to the right. Play fake. Bryant's going to throw again. They're going to complete to Mendoza. He's got the first down at the 30 and gets pushed down across the 25 down to the 24, and that'll move the chains for the Golden Beavers with 1:42 left, and there's an injured Slinger player down on the field.
Injury timeout on the field.
We'll keep it right here. Coach, got muscles, Coach?
Nope.
Athletes of all levels, even at your level, need to train to build muscles and rebuild and repair muscles after they practice and compete. Containing 13 nutrients, white and low-fat chocolate milk's high-quality proteins offer athletes an edge over traditional sports and other protein drinks. That's why so many professional athletes include milk in their core part of their training diet. And recommend milk for aspiring athletes as well. Learn more at GonnaNeedMilk.com, brought to you by the Dairy Farmers of Wisconsin. Also appreciate the Beaver Dam Unified School District for helping and being a part of the broadcast here today. If you want to stay up to date with everything going on at the Beaver Dam Unified School District, check out BDUSD.org. You can watch the school board meetings, Coach. You can find information about employment. You can get the contact information from your schools.
Got everything.
You got everything.
Got everything.
Even your email address is on there if you don't like anything you say.
Yeah, let
me
know.
LADRON.
Appreciate it.
Ladron. Timothy.
A couple scores. Badger Conference related. Want to keys out to an early 21-0 lead. But Sun Prairie West, an 8 seed, a 7-0 lead at the end of one over Sussex Hamilton.
All right, 1:42 left here. Working off the near hash at the 25-yard line. Bryant, play fake again, rolling to his right. Got some time. He's going to throw it to the corner. He's got Kyler Keel. He's going to make the catch. Dives to the pylon. Is he in the end zone? No. They're going to say he stepped out inside the five, maybe at the three.
An absolute dime by Eli Bryant. Keel wide open, ran a great route to the corner. And Bryant rolling left through a beauty.
It'll be first and goal for the Golden Beavers. You're going to mark it at the two. And it looks like Slinger is going to take a timeout. We'll keep it right here as Slinger takes a timeout with his first and goal, Coach. And, you know, they're rolling Eli Bryant out. He's having some time. He's having some success.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, they found something, right? They're getting in some time. They're rolling them out, as you said, and our receivers are beating their guys in the secondary right now. And so it might be a reverse action, right? So the passing game might end up setting up the running game here a little bit, but they're getting some action through the air. Now it's going to be tough because that first and goal on the two where everything's going to be stacked in, now it's going to be the test.
Braden Strakota's mom, grandma checking in from Milwaukee. He says, go Beavers. What do you got on the YouTube, Coach? Anybody checking in? That's of note. That's
let's see. We got Jeannie Malik. Go Beavers. Moose Grandma. I think you said that one already. I missed that one.
I didn't.
No. Okay.
That's all we got.
I think we covered everything else.
94.
I think we got everybody else.
94 seconds left in the far hash. Beavers knock it on the door. First and goal. They'll work out of the pistol. Power to the left. They're going to motion Keel, and they fumbled the football. Keel's going to pick it up and cut it back inside. Kyler just got rocked. Flag on the play, and he got hammered again. This is a real physical Slinger team, isn't it?
I got to tell you, I sort of feel like that's got to be a flag too. I don't know how it's not.
They're going to call a hold on Beaver Dam. If you're a pro wrestling fan, that was a suplex.
Back suplex. There you go.
Yes.
Not that you're not a bet wrestling fan.
Oh, no, yeah, you're right. But
you got that call right there.
So the Beaver's going to – this may actually help them a little bit, Coach.
Yeah, the space a little bit. I think it might. So you got Jim Shorts, Gut Check Time, Moose, Go Green and Gold.
You can send us an email, sports@dailydodge.com. If you want to comment on the YouTube page, you have to subscribe to leave a comment. Is that correct, Ninja?
Slinger? Oh, so the Slinger declines the penalty, okay. And Beaverdam ends up with a loss of 7 on the play.
So it's going to be second down and goal from the...
So he doesn't get any forward progress out of that either?
Yeah, because where the suplex landed is where they marked it.
Yeah.
I think they're talking about the... There's confusion on... the official's now going to talk about it. Yeah, right, because he was up, got back to about the 5, didn't he?
The holding call was down on the 2.
Yeah.
He was close to the 2, back to the line of scrimmage, it looked like.
There's 1:28 left.
End of 1, Houstacon 13, Oostburg 7.
I expect Houstacon to get to the final 4 in their division. Jason Fiacco's done an unbelievable job with that squad. In my WISSports.net predictions.
Over on the other Daily Dodge channel, we got Columbus 7, Broadhead Judah 0. Near the end of the first.
Colton Brunell needs 182 yards to become the state's all-time leading rusher.
That's unbelievable. He had 24-yard touchdown run
there. And we talked about it. And remember, he has a COVID year mixed in there, too. Where things weren't all.
Yeah,
you know,
that's right.
You know, he didn't play.
That's unbelievable.
You know, you didn't get the full run of games.
Did they play the spring season? Is that how that worked?
That's a long time ago,
no,
Coach.
No, I know. Well, you know, I figured maybe you might know. I don't know. I apologize for calling you out on that
that's
one.
That's all right. I can go back and look. A good color guy would just have that information for me.
Yeah.
Well, I bet you Mark DeStefano.
You got to find one first.
Mark
DeStefano probably has one.
He probably would have had it.
Okay, so now it looks like they took the penalty, and so now it's going to be at the 11.
Yeah, Mark DeStefano surely would have had that in his notes. So it'll be first and goal from the 12 now. And, again, I think this may help Beaver Dam a little bit. George and Keel to the near side. Mendoza heavy to the right. Play fake, all Mendoza's leaning. They're going to throw to the corner of the end zone. Leo George off his fingertips. And let's see if it pushes the Beavers back 5 more. Now I'm going to say it's not going to help them.
Yeah.
They're going to push this back to the 17.
Well, so if it's an illegal shift, though.
Cameron was leaning, and somebody else was in motion.
Are they going to take it? They decline it.
So it'll be second down and goal.
I'll tell you what, I like the adjustment of the game plan by Coach Lindy and his staff, finding something through the air. And that seems to be where the space is tonight.
1:14 left in the first, no score. Second and goal from the 12 for the Golden Beavers. Barnes will dot the I. Bryant going to roll to the right side again. He's going to heave it to the corner again. Kyler Keel catches it into the end zone. Touchdown, Golden Beavers. He beat Jesse Retzloff, and Beaver Dam leads 6-0.
That is a 12-yard touchdown pass and another beautiful throw by Bryant. That one-on-one coverage with Kyler Keel in his speed beats the coverage. Great ball. Touchdown, Beaver Dam.
So the Beavers through the air take the lead. With 1:09 left in the quarter, here's the extra point squad. Good snap. The extra point is up, and it is good. 1:09 left in the first quarter. 7-0 Beaver Dam on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
10% off all brand new 2023 Jeep Grand Cherokees and Compasses during the Jeep Adventure Days event at Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Beaver Dam. Hello, this is Brent Reed, and with savings in excess of $7,000 on select models, there's never been a better time to upgrade your ride. And that's not all. Fall savings are definitely in the air with $10,000 off select Ram Bighorn crew cabs while supplies last. Let our family take care of your family at Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Beaver Dam and ReedChrysler.com.
At Preferred Dental Partners, our core values are more than just something we put on our wall. They're something we live out. Core value number 3 is compassionate care. Over the years, we've learned a very important anatomy lesson. There are humans attached to the mouths we treat, and we know humans are complex with many needs beyond their teeth. Whether it's the anxiety that accompanies walking into the door of a dental office, or when you're trying to juggle all life is throwing at you, we get it. If you're looking for some compassion with your dental care, call Preferred Dental Partners today.
Well, Coach, Beaver Dam takes advantage of the Slinger fake punt and marches down the field.
Yeah, 9-play, 44-yard drive, 1:31 off the clock. It's Eli Bryant to Kyler Keel with a 12-yard touchdown pass. Parker Blank's kick is good. 7-0, Beaver Dam.
All right, Beaver Dam doing it on both sides of the ball here early. Kicking off for the Golden Beavers will be Cameron Mendoza. Thanks for coming on board tonight, whether you're a fan of Slinger or Beaver Dam. Little.
Yep.
Beavers were offsides.
Yep.
That'll cost them five.
The Eberleys are checking in.
Oh, the Eberleys checking in. Who is it?
Christine.
Oh, Christine. Hello.
From home.
Checking in. Did it just wrapped up a Skylar and Christine? Just wrapped up a great eighth grade volleyball middle school season. Did a great job with the middle schoolers.
Okay, so I'm going to pull. Don Carroll only got seven text messages.
Come on,
there's got to be more than that.
She's
come
on the
there's,
Slinger
there's
side.
There's way, way more people that are listening to us right now that have Don Carroll's number. Let's text her and tell her what are you doing sitting over here?
You call her a traitor?
Yeah, do that. That sounds good. I like it.
Can I just give her number on the air? oh, onside kick, and the Beavers going to recover it. They hammered it at the front line, and let's see who covered it up. Oh, Slinger got it back. It looked like that they had it, Coach, didn't
it? Yeah, it did look like it looked like somebody had it for us. Couldn't tell who it was. It must have lost the initial possession, and now Slinger is going to get set up with great field position. I don't think that was necessarily an onside kick. I think it's just a low kick that ended up hammering the lineman, and Slinger's going to start on our 46.
See, Bruce Kaufman reminded me that Columbus played in the spring, and they played all their games at Fall River because they were in Columbia County. I think
that's
they had
right.
to move to.
That's right.
It's good field position for the Owls here, moving to our left at the Beaver Dam 46. Hand off on the right side to Burkle again. He's going to weave his way through down to about the 42-yard line. Boy, were they trying to hammer it off one of the players, do you think?
I don't think so. I think it was just Cameron kicking a low ball hard, and I think it just happened to hit a lineman.
50 seconds left in the first quarter. 7-0 Beaver Dam. Beaver Dam football presented by Columbus Family Dental, Hometown Glass and Improvement, and the Beaver Dam Unified School District. Mark DeStefano checking into the broadcast today. Could have done a three-man booth here today. Second down and six. Thede, long count, low snap, play fake. He's going to throw. Here comes the pressure. Heaves it up over the middle. It's caught by Lydell. He's going to break a tackle and then carry a tackler down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. Boston Damon made the tackle, and the Owls are in business.
It's a 35-yard pickup. Longest one of the night for Slinger.
Going to wind the clock with 15 seconds left. Let's see if the Owls will try to run another play.
Wait, just along with that big line, there's some explosive weapons on the perimeter. I think Slinger's going to let the clock run out the
end of
the quarter. All
right, we played the first 12 minutes of this first round playoff game. Beaver Dam 7, Slinger nothing, back in 60 seconds on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
American drivers overpay an average of $368 per year on their auto insurance. Why? Because, well, insurance is hard. It's complicated. It's time-consuming to get quotes from multiple companies, so we overpay. Or we call Richards Insurance in Beaver Dam. Make one call and receive a quote from a great company like Auto Owners Insurance. The team at Richards Insurance will literally do all the work for you. So if you could be saving money each month with an Auto Owners Insurance policy, you'll know about it. How much will you save with Richards Insurance? To find out, call Richards Insurance or stop in at 123 North Spring Street, downtown Beaver Dam. With offices in Columbus, Watertown, West Bend, and Oshkosh. With over 50 employees and hundreds of years insurance experience across five offices, you'll get full service counseling with no obligation. Your auto owner's insurance carrier is Richards Insurance in Beaver Dam. Call 887-1615.
We'll be there with you.
Richards Insurance of Beaver Dam.
Back at Slinger, Wade Bates and Tim Ladron, 7-0 Beaver Dam with the Owls driving here, first and goal at the 7. Now, do we have to bring Dawn Carroll up to explain herself? Because she is a Slinger graduate.
Yeah.
But my question is, you're a Watertown graduate. Did you sit on the Watertown side when they played?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
I don't. Is she a Slinger or a Hartford graduate?
I don't know. Somewhere around here. Okay, Hartford. First and goal for the Owls on the 7-yard line, working the near hash. Low snap, hand off to Burkle right side, and he's going to spin through one tackler, and then he's going to get corralled by a bunch of Beavers. Yeah, she so really doesn't have an excuse, does she, if she's
no.
Hartford?
No.
She said her family lives here, though. This is a beautiful community, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. It just, I mean, it just growing. I mean, crazy how fast it grows here. But, yeah, and the facilities are great. And
did a baseball game here a couple of years ago, like the baseball field. Standing room only here on the Slingers side as well.
Yep.
Again, you can see the Beaver Dam crowd, which is heavy on the far side of the field. Well, it's a long walk over there, so I understand if Dawn didn't, you know, want to walk over there. It's second down and goal from the 6. A couple of wide receivers to the far side. They'll motion one to the near side as well. Burkle's going to stand to the right of Thede. Thede's going to throw. Left side was knocked down. Did he fumble the football? I think he did. He went to throw it, and it popped out of his hand, and it's going to be a third down and goal. They went backwards like Beaver Dam went backwards on that end.
That's going to be a loss of 9.
So it's third and goal.
Those, you know, in a playoff game like this, those are kind of the breaks you need, right? You need some of those plays to happen your way.
We've answered the question about the front seven, at least early in this one, or the Beavers have a scheme, and Coach Lindy's always so, you know, he's a great offensive mind in his staff.
Yep.
They've kind of figured it out where they move the football here. Trips to the far side, second and goal, make it third and goal from the 15-yard line. Thede's going to throw, rolls to his left. Here comes the pressure again, goes back on. It's nearly intercepted, and then it's going to be caught into the end zone. Oh, they're going to say short. They're going to say that Joey Micknick was short, but, boy, Thede threw a BB right there, and how did Micknick make that catch in traffic, Coach?
Yeah, there was two Beaver Dam defenders right there, and Micknick went over the top of them and made the play, and then still ended up making a nice run and nearly getting into the house. And now it's fourth and goal at the 1 where Beaver Dam could still get a stop here.
Fourth and goal from the 1 just inside the far hash, 9:54 left in the first half. They're going to have Burkle in the backfield with Thede, that big old offensive line on the right side. They've got everybody in tight. Lockstead as well in the backfield. Hand off to Thede, and he's going to get into the end zone. Touchdown, Slinger.
Well, it all started with that short kick that gave good field position to Slinger, and they capitalize on it. And this extra point could tie it up. This is Cole Martin, 6 foot, 190-pound offensive lineman.
Extra point is up and good. 9:40 left in the first half. Beaver Dam 7, Slinger 7 on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam. Back in 60 seconds.
Hi, I'm Josh Schneider with Silica for your home. We have a great feature available in our showrooms, our digital price tags. They search the internet every day and allow us to adjust the prices based on our competitors. That ensures you are always getting the best deal. If it finds a lower price, it will automatically change our Silica price in real time. These digital price tags are all about saving you time and money. Shop Silica for your home for the best sales, service, and selection.
Hey, it's Stacy with Slumberland, Beaver Dam in Watertown. Stop in and see everything that our store has to offer. We built it just for you. We have mattresses, box springs, power bases, bedroom sets, furniture, living room sets, dining sets, everything that you would need to complete your entire home. We've got our interest-free financing and a really great local staff here to help you. So you've got all local people here to help you out from start to finish for anything that you would need. So stop in, shop local, and save big with us.
Seven Beaver Dam and Slinger here. The kickoff, an end-over-end kick from Cole Martin, going to be taken at the 1-yard line by the Beavers on the right side, weaving through traffic up to the 21. Maybe the 22-yard line was Avery Prewee, and that's where the Beavers will start, first and 10.
Well, Beaver Dam's turn to answer the call here.
Got a check-in from Grudzinski, Korber, and Durenberger. That sounds like a law firm. Families, I may have butchered all of your names. I'm sorry, from Slinger, saying go Owls. Liam Benz on the stop, along with Ethan Miller. Of course, Hand off to Barnes, right side up the middle. Josiah has a little bit of a hole, and he's going to keep weaving his way towards the 30. Gain of about 7 or 8.
Yeah, nice job by Josiah to keep his arms going, or to keep his legs going there.
Hey, the Hemling family is cheering on BD football at home. There's some great student athletes out there on the field. See, Owen Hemling got a little love on Fox 6.
Yeah, that was cool. That was really neat.
I think on the fair, Owen ended up on the air with us like 10 times. Talked to him about his roosters, then he came back and talked about something else and something else and something else. Very involved in the community. 9 minutes left in the half, 7-7. Second down and 2 for the Golden Beavers at their own 30. Bryant pump fake, rights and all. They did a hitch and go, and they got Freund wide open, and Jeffrey gets overshot at the 40. What a great route by Jeffrey.
Yeah, it was. The defensive back bit, and Jeffrey had him beat. Just a little bit overthrown by Eli. A good route. End of one, a little bit of a shocker. Sun Prairie East, a 2-seed, down 15-14 to Hartford.
Wisconsin Little 10, old Little 10 here today. Third down and we'll call it officially 3. Third and 2. Far hash at the 35. Hand off to Mendoza. The Mendoza hammers through a couple of tacklers up across the 40 to the 42-yard line. That'll move the chains.
Pick up Cameron running with some intent. Picks up 12 and a first down.
Columbus is up 21-0, it looks like, on Broadhead.
I don't think Columbus is super happy about the seed when that came out.
No. Again, Andy Selgrad's so mad at me for not picking him to win. It's on their bulletin board. First and 10. Hand off to Barnes again. Josiah gets a block to the outside by Mendoza. He's at the 50, the 45. There goes Josiah Barnes at the 30. Cuts it back. Still on his feet. Barnes busts through inside the 10-yard line. Josiah Barnes. Huge run. It's first and goal, Golden Beavers.
Boy, that's a pickup of 50 for Barnes. And you called it, Wade. It was the Cameron Mendoza block on the end that sprung him, and then he broke a couple tackles late, but that block by Mendoza was huge.
Leo George splits wide to the right. To the near side, it's Kyler Keel. Play fake, Bryant rolls to the right side. He has George in the end zone. Caught it, touchdown, Golden Beavers! Leo George stretches out. It's 13-7 BD.
I mean, everything right there. Another rollout for Eli. He throws a great ball and a great catch by Leo George. And Beaver Dam's offense looks as good as it has all year.
You saw that thing develop. And, boy, the routes that these receivers are running today, Coach, they were ready. And Coach said they had their best practice of the week this week, all week long. Comes the extra point, and it is good. 7:54 left in the half. Beaver Dam 14, Slinger 7. It's Golden Beaver football on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
At Summit Ford Beaver Dam, we are committed to serving the customers in our community, to bringing you into our dealership, and making the buying process easy, fun, stress-free, and memorable. Thank you for choosing us and voting us Dodge County's best place to buy a new or used vehicle. Stop in today for a test drive and to see how we can help you find the car of your dreams. Summit Ford Beaver Dam.
If this heat has you realizing it's time to upgrade your home's air conditioning, don't waste another minute or another dollar on wasted energy. Call Surefire today to see how much you could save with a new high-efficiency Lennox air conditioning system. Stay cool and stay calm, knowing Surefire is here for you with 24/7 customer service. Call us at 920-485-4883 or visit us online at surefireinc.com.
Wade Bates and Tim Ladron back on the TV side. Never left on the radio side, Coach.
It's a four-play, 78-yard drive. Only takes 1:40 off the clock. Eli Bryant to Leo George, 8-yard touchdown pass. Kick is good. A 5-yard running into the kicker penalty. Obsessed on the kickoff. Beaver Dam kicking from the 45 here.
All right, so Beaver Dam Little squib kick again. It's going to be, oh, it's loose on the turf. It's still loose. The Beavers covered it up. Boston Damon covered up the squib kick, and they have it again.
Again, we look at the sideline for Beaver Dam. They are fired up right now. All the momentum on Beaver Dam's side. We're sitting over here on the Slinger side. It's really quiet over here right now. Beaver Dam's got a ton of momentum, a chance to punch another one in.
Beavers will have it at the 33-yard line.
That was one of those kind of, ball was kind of spinning off its top a little bit. It had a ton of spin, too. It was tough for the Slinger kid to pick it up. Obviously bobbled it, Boston Damon on top of it.
Mark it at the 32. Four wide receivers for the Golden Beavers. They have a lineman out wide here, Coach. Bryant's going to throw, and he's got the draw. Right side 30, 25, down inside the 20 to the 22. Beaver Dam had Isaac Monheim split out as wide receiver, but he was covering up. He technically was a tackle, right?
Yeah. We haven't seen that all year out of Beaver Dam, having Eli Bryant take off and run, and that picks up a nice 10 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 22.
So the Beavers will have it first down, 7:33 left. Here in the first half, already up 14-7, looking for more. And we're going to get a whistle, and Slinger is going to take another timeout, and we'll keep it right here for that, coach. They're on their heels.
Yeah, and their head coach, they're getting everybody together right now. And this is like one of those basketball timeouts where you got to get everybody together and get settled down, because Slinger over on the sideline looks like a mess.
Beaver's punched him in the mouth.
They really have. I think Slinger came in here thinking this was their football game, and I think, like you said, the punch in the mouth from Beaver Nam has been impressive and really is shocking this Slinger football team and this crowd.
We've got the Schweigers are carving pumpkins and cheering on the Beavers. It's a nice catch, Leo George, for a touchdown.
Boy, Columbus up 28-0 now, as they're just putting the hammer to it early.
It's 14-7 here with 7:22 left in the first half.
What a great start so far. A long way to go, but Beaver Dam's got all kinds of momentum here.
They'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Receivers split to each side. Barnes going to dot the I. Eli Bryant going to throw. He's got some time again. Heaves it up over the middle, looking for Jeffrey Freund in the end zone. He caught it. Touchdown, Golden Beavers. Jeffrey Freund from 22 yards out.
I mean, Slinger hasn't adjusted at all. They stay in that 4-4 with single coverage on the perimeter. And listen, George and Keel and Freund can fly. Those are tough guys to cover one-on-one, especially if you're not getting enough pass rush. A beautiful ball from Eli. Jeffrey Freund with an unbelievable catch.
The Beavers back on the board. Extra point is up, and it is good. 7:15 left in the half. Beaver Dam 21, Slinger 7. Back in 60 seconds at 14:30 ESPN and Daily Dodge TV.
Are you ready for peace of mind? Chad Guzzi here, owner of Air Care in Beaver Dam. If you're tired of unexpected repair bills, you want to sign up for our Total Care plan. It ensures top performance and prolonged life of your heating and air conditioning equipment. Air Care's Total Care customers receive annual inspections as well as a reduced maintenance rate, plus a 10% discount on all service repairs. Air Care, big enough to serve you, small enough to care. 920-356-8860.
Join the American Packaging team and help create packaging for some of the most iconic brands in the world. Sarah says the benefits at American Packaging are fantastic.
At American Packaging, we have a great 401k match. They match us 75 cents for every dollar up to 5%. And we get quarterly bonuses. If we meet our budget, we get a Christmas bonus. If you've been here 5 years, you will also get a seniority bonus.
Learn more about joining the American Packaging team in Columbus and DeForest by checking out the careers page at AmericanPackaging.com.
You know, they've had their best practice week of the year, Coach, and so far they've looked had their best quarter and a half in the year, I think.
Yeah, unbelievable. Two plays, 32 yards. Bryant to Freund, 37 seconds off the clock. 21-7 Beaver Dam.
Beavers were offsides again on the kickoff. Got him right where they want him now, right?
Eli Bryant is 8 of 13 for 97 yards and 3 touchdowns. His last 3 completions have been touchdown passes, and they've all been to different guys. Keel has one, George has one, and Freund has one.
.715 left. We're working on the clock for those of you that keep asking. Luke and Cody Gartland watching the game from home saying, go BD. Go Beavers from the Coonses. Was that an intentional onside kick? The second one's a squib kick as well, and that's going to roll out of bounds. That was their close. You know, Slinger didn't make a real effort to get that football, did they?
No, they didn't. And, boy, Avery Femright almost got to that one on the sideline.
Knock it back in?
Yeah. He was close.
Ninja, they're at least asking if he can swing around and shoot the scoreboard every now and then to get the clock.
I can't see it from here.
Yeah, with the angle of where we're at in our window inside our booth to get the walls in the way of it. Oh, you try.
Ninja's a professional.
There you go. There you go.
Otherwise, this is what they get.
Yes, 7:15. All right, they'll have it at the 43-yard line. Slinger down 21-7 with 7:15 left. Thede going to work out of a shotgun, two wides to the near side. Looks like they're talking about the spot, and now I think they got it where they want it. And here we go. And the Beavers lined up off sides. Yep. It's a big tee.
Big tees.
Big
tees. Still in a stance.
That's going to cost them 5 more.
Encroachment, Beaver Dam.
So it'll be 1st and 5.
5-yard penalty.
Well, it'd be interesting here because see what Slinger does. I mean, they ran the ball really well. They've run the ball pretty well. But, you know, they start to panic a little bit.
1st and 5. That'll push it up to the 47 right side. Burkle's got some room, and he's going to pound his way across the 50 down to the 44-yard line, and that'll move the chains for the Owls with 7:10 left.
Nice power run up the middle. Again, that offensive line just big and has the capability of creating some holes.
Mike Thede, 17 touchdowns, 3 picks this year. He's got a rocket of an arm. A couple of wide receivers to the near side for the Owls, moving to our right. Beaver Dam's up 21-7. High snap, going to hand off to Burkle again, races to the outside, slides through. Look at him carry tacklers. Up near the 30, down near the 36-yard line.
I'm going to butcher this name, but Owen Klavikowski?
Klavikowski, yep.
Oh, I didn't butcher
you.
Yep. He's checking in. 36.
Hello, Owen.
Thanks, Owen.
You can also send an email to sports@dailydodge.com. Just put BD or Slinger in these headlines so Tronson doesn't read it for us. Rob, Melissa, and Camden Zerkinski. See, now I butchered the name there, Coach. Hold on a second. A couple of wides to the near side. Thede's going to throw. Here comes the pressure. Steps up, heaves it over the middle, and it's going to be inter. Oh, nearly intercepted by A.J. Sweeney. Oh, he had that thing.
He did. He did. That's actually the first incompletion for Thede on the night. Oh, Zerkinski.
Yes.
Yep.
Rob, Melissa, and Camden.
Yep.
Oh, Sweeney,
great people.
Thede threw into quadruple coverage here. It almost threaded the needle. Sweeney came from all the way to the near side of the field.
And it looked like it was a ball he probably should have had, but does make a nice play. And again, Thede's first incompletion. He's been really good. 5 of 6 for 60 yards.
Wide to the left is Lytle. A couple of wide receivers to the near side. Again, they're putting big number 99, Cade Lockstead, out wide. And now they're going to get a timeout call. There's some confusion. Again, Slinger takes the timeout. That's their third timeout of the half, right?
Yeah.
They're just discombobulated.
Yep.
The guys.
99's not happy. Yeah,
even from the start, when they ran on the field and kind of ran into the Beaver Dam and National Anthem, you know, they came in with, trying to.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're trying to say this is our house or what.
Yeah. It was a weird situation because Beaver Dam's lined up for the anthem at the 45, and you know they're going to run out to the field in the middle of their logo, but the flag waving right at them and the whole thing and starting that thing. But yeah, it just feel like Beaver Dam's been the more maybe composed football team tonight so far. I mean, long way to go.
Yes,
I mean this is far from over, and you can tell just what Slinger's got that they got a chance to score just about at any play.
Third and three for the Beaver Dam 36-yard line. Thede working out of the shotgun. Three wides, moving to our right. He's going to throw me at movement at the line of scrimmage. I think that Jack Klippel leaned a little early.
Yeah, that's what I had too, Wade. That's what I had too.
Go from third and three to think 3 - 5 = 8, right?
Well, there you go. Who says he can't do math?
Eberly's out there. She teaches math. Was that correct? She can. If I'm wrong, we can go to her. So it's I'm not sure about Sky's math, though.
Yeah, well he married a math teacher, so it doesn't matter.
You're right.
It doesn't matter. Like, it could be whatever it is.
The market back to the 41. A couple of wides to the far side. Third and 8. 5:56 left here in the first half. Thede's going to throw. Here comes the pressure again. Oh, Thede let her rip, and he completed it on the far side to Lydell as he took a huge shot from, was that Vitense over there?
It was Vitense, but, boy, impressive. And Lytle's going to be down. And trainer's coming out to take a look at him. It's a pickup of 29 on the play for the first down.
As he, I don't know how he got wrestled down. Did he take a shot? I was actually looking at Thede staying in the pocket there because he was watching Vitense come in. He just stood in the pocket and delivered a BB.
I think that was more, it was more of a wrestle down instead of a shot. I mean, he's been great. Lytle's 5 catches for 83 yards already. He's been a big factor. They can't afford to lose him.
I love watching Thede throw as well,
Stands tall in that pocket.
6'1", 180. He's going to play at the next level.
Yeah, good arm, runs well.
And good to know that Lytle is back on his feet.
And Thede only a junior.
This Slinger team next year, coach, is going to be really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they were picked to win the North Shore this year by Travis Wilson.
That's saying something. When you talk about teams like Homestead. I mean, that's... That's saying something.
So it'll be first and 10. They'll mark it at the 11. Trips to the far side for the Owls with 5:48 left. First half, they trail 21-7. Level one playoff action. Winner hosts Germantown next week. Hand off right side up the middle, actually cutting back inside was Klippel, and he's going to get a couple. So if Germantown win, we're not that far away. They probably jumped in the car and came up here.
Oh, yeah. Well, the game was in Milwaukee, but yeah, for sure. I would think they'd have coaches ready to go and get up here and see.
Probably got some Germantown folks watching on the stream. If you're out there, send us an email, sports@dailydodge.com. Remember Justin Hull, everybody in Germantown? I'm going to use that next week. Caught the game-winning touchdown back in the day. It was in my wedding. Hand off right side. Going to try to break to the corner. Klippel, and he's near the goal line. Does he get to the end zone? He does. Touchdown, Slinger. Jack Klippel. And the Owls answer.
That was the type of answer that Slinger needed. And that's what they do, through the ground and through the air. They've been really, you can tell they're just really, really solid. Cole Martin, the kicker here, he's 38 of 39 from extra points on the year.
Extra point is up, and it is... good. 5:02 left in the first half. Beaver Dam 21, Slinger 14. This is Golden Beaver Football on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
The teams at Beaver Dam and Mayville Tire and Service are growing and adding service technicians and auto lube technicians. Work in a clean shop environment with a fun and friendly team that is committed to excellence and customer satisfaction. Competitive pay based on experience, full benefits, including health, dental, 401k. Join the growing team at Beaver Dam and Mayville Tire and Service. Find full job postings on Facebook or visit either location to submit your resume.
Hi, this is Dr. Adam Forster at Columbus Family Dental. If you've been unhappy with your smile, it's time that you come and see us. Our team of doctors are waiting to help you get your smile back. We'll take the time to talk with you and treat you like a member of our family, not just another number. Whether it's a whole mouth makeover or simply a little tweak, we'll find the right solution that fits you. For your free, no-pressure consultation, call us today at 623-5559.
With 5:02 left in the first half, Wade Bates, Tim Ladron, Justin Wilski here. Level one, Division two playoff game. It's been a fun one through the first half. End over end kick. Freund's going to take it at the goal line up to the 10, the 15. Jeffrey hurdles somebody up to the 20-yard line, and that's where the Golden Beavers will start first and 10. So I guess the Schweigers, the Tuns, the, who else? I got a bunch of people carving pumpkins tonight and watching the game. The Matuszewskis and the Schmitz are all carving pumpkins and watching the Golden Beavers. Thanks, Dale, for that.
Jeff Boyd on the return for the Golden Beavers.
4:56 left. Single wide receivers to each side. Hand off up the middle to Barnes. Going to bust it back to the right side. He's going to slide through for a gain of five up to the 25-yard line. Nice gain of five tackle on the play. I like zero. Jesse Retzloff. Yeah. Single zero.
Is it legal to have a single zero and a double zero?
I probably could, yeah. Well, different numbers.
I know Bruce Kaufman's listening. Yeah, let us know.
Bruce.
Single zero, double zero?
Can I have them both on the field? Deuce receivers to the near side. Second down and five. Bryant rolling out to the near side. Oh, he's got Leo George again all by himself, but Eli's going to tuck it down. He's got the 30, 35 up to the 38-yard line. Tackled from behind again by Retzloff. Boy, our wide receivers, coach, they're getting wide open.
Yeah, everybody's open. That would have been a tough throw. I mean, yeah. Again, Eli Rowan left, and George is going right and away from him. Like, that's a really tough throw. I think it's a good decision by Eli. Tucks it, gets 12.
Tucked it and moved the chains. Only Jordan Love would have done that at the end of the Raider game, right? Like a week and a half ago. We have had a chance.
Don't get
to
me started on that.
Okay.
I'm having a good night tonight.
Bryant's going to work out of the shotgun. We're below 4 minutes left in the half. Bryant's going to throw again. Screen on the right side to Keel. Makes a catch. Makes a guy miss. 45, 50. Keel got upended into Owl territory by Weston Fogel. But it's first and 10, Golden Beavers. Moving the chains, leading 21-14.
I mean, again, we haven't seen us throw it this much all year. We know Eli's capable of it, but just in a really solid rhythm. And again, it starts up front, and the coaching staff, again, is doing a really good job of moving Eli out of the pocket, get him on the move. He's such a good athlete. It's tough for those linemen to get to him.
Keel in single coverage over here against Santos Rodriguez. Bryant. Hand off to Barnes, who turns it inside. He's going to punch across the 45 down to about the 42. A late flag came in. Came in from the back judge. Wait and see what we saw. What he saw. It's gonna, is that going to go on Beaver Dam? The flag came in at the tackle.
Personal foul. That's what this the near guy says here. Yep, personal foul.
Personal foul called on. So
that'll cost the Beavers.
Not sure what that was.
Brock Collin, Coach Lindy was happy about that when he's taking a walk. That came in late, so I don't know if something happened on the tackle.
Maybe a late block or somebody say something. Okay, sets up first and 20.
First down and 20, as you mentioned, back into Golden Beaver territory. Bryant, they've got the screen to Keel. He's going to make the catch across the 45. Kyler across the 50 got tackled from behind down at the 47-yard line. Tackle from behind right there made by Gavin Constantino. Coach, for $5, spell Constantino without looking at your roster.
Nope. Great block out here by Moose to spring Keel on that.
Second down and 8. Mendoza, Barnes in the backfield. Play fake again. Bryant's going to roll to the right. He's going to heave it, and he throws it high. It was caught by Keel, who got hammered and made the catch to move the chains.
Keel got hammered, and Bryant got hammered, and they still complete a 10-yard pass for first down.
Ball spotted at the 36.
What's Bryant's yardage right now?
135. Keel is 6 catches for 86. Eli's completed his last 5.
Pair of wide receivers, clock winding at 2:05 left in the half. Beavers moving to our left, leading 21-14. Play fake again. Bryant right side up over the middle, and it's nearly intercepted. Throwing into a traffic, looking for the moose, and nearly picked off by Chase Leverance. It'll be second down.
And we got a little lucky on that one, and Mendoza leaked out toward the Beaver Dam sideline. It's pretty wide open over on that side. Eli just missed him.
So it'll be second down and a 10. Keel, there's still single coverage in the wide receivers, coach, all night. Hand off to Barnes, right side. He's got a hole of a 30. Josiah busted to the outside. He is going to get the first down and get out of bounds inside the 25-yard line with 1:50 left. Tough running from Josiah Barnes.
Well, and he had that one big one for 50, but really the last 5 carries have been really solid. He's at 9 for 86. We said before it was going to be tough for us to get on the ground, but what's happened is this pass game has really opened that up.
Keel on the right side, George to the near side. Again, Barnes will dot the eye. Mendoza slot to the right. First down for Beaver Dam. Play fake again. Here comes the pressure. Bryant's going to heave it to the corner. There's contact and looking for a flag. Not going to get it. It'll be second down and 10 as they look for Mendoza. Marshall leads Howard's Grove 8-6 at the half. Coach Kleinhein's squad. Big Jer gave us that one.
Eli did a nice job there, really hanging in the pocket with that pressure coming in there. Really stuck in there.
Big drive for the Golden Beavers here. George wide to the right. To the near side, it's Keel. Bryant out of the pistol. Play hand off to Barnes again. He got nothing right there, but Josiah running hard is going to get to the 25. It's going to be third and 10. Coach, I can't even remember because it's so long ago. Who got the opening kickoff? Beaver Dam received?
We did. I like the run call there, though, because Slinger can't stop it, right? So with 1:22 left, third down, it keeps that clock running, doesn't give them an opportunity. Now Beaver Dam maybe can take a shot or two here.
Because you're in no man's land. You're going to go for it. Four down territory here. Keel wide to the right. Leo George split way wide to the left. Bryant out of the pistol. 1 minute left in the first half. And we're going to get a timeout called by Brock Lindy, and we'll keep it right here as he'll take a timeout. And we will remind you that we appreciate the WIAA being along with us here on this broadcast. And when you're faced with a challenge, how you respond, coach, determines the real winners. Rural Mutual believes there's something more important than just winning or losing a game. They believe that the team, the school, and the fans who support their athletes with dignity and class are the true champions. Rural Mutual is the proud sponsor of the WIAA Rural Mutual Insurance Sportsmanship Award since it started in 1965. From football to volleyball, soccer to tennis, the award recognizes more than team sportsmanship. It recognizes that sportsmanship matters, coach, in your community as well. Visit ruralmutual.com/WIAA and see how our team and your community can work together to be a true champion.
Corey Sparks checks in at YouTube. It says, when was Beaver Dam's last playoff win?
2011.
A win over, I always get it confused, whether it was Hortonville or New London. It's one of those two. It was at home. Then they end up losing the next game to the Forest.
Third down, and we'll call it 11. Bryant's going to throw. Here comes the pressure. Up over the middle. He throws it high, looking for the moose, and that was knocked away at the last second by Weston Fogel, and it's fourth down.
And that time, the Slinger defense made an adjustment. They dropped out of their package, and they played a cover four there, and there wasn't a whole lot of room to hit anything. And again, they set up fourth down. You mentioned it, Wade. This is goal four territory here. One thing that's happened here, Cameron Mendoza sitting on the sideline on the bench there. I don't know if it's cramps or whatever, but I came out after the last play. That's a big deal for Beaver Dam, especially with his blocking.
Fourth down and 10 from the 27-yard line of Slinger. Bryant's going to throw. They're going to throw the corner route to Freund, heaving it up. Can Jeffrey get there? Just overshoots him in the end zone, and the Beavers will give it back to the Owls with 46 seconds left. But the way the Slinger wideouts can run, you know, the Owls are probably going to keep their foot on the gas here.
Yeah, I think they probably feel like they need to, even though they don't have timeouts left. I mean, we know the clock stops on a first down until the chains get set, so they'll have some time if they can pick some up. Beaver Dam's got to do a good job getting some pass rush. And again, Mendoza does not look like he's out there. And that's a big deal with the pass rush for sure.
Also, a $25 fine for Big Jer because it's Howard's Grove 6, Marshall nothing at the half. $25, the Good Karma Brands, John Moser Children's Radiothon, Big Jer. Thede's going to work out of the shotgun, three wides to the far side. I got a handoff to Burkle, and he is going to, he breaks a tackle. Burkle goes to the outside. Little stutter step on Boston Damon. He is off to the races, cuts it back inside, down to the 20-yard line. And all of a sudden, Slinger with 35 seconds left in the half. They don't have timeouts. Vitense is hurt. He's trying to get off the field, so that's going to actually help out the Golden Beavers a little bit here. Beavers, they're going to play with 10. Brock Lindy may have to take a timeout, or do we have an injury timeout? It's an official's timeout for Beaver Dam because Vitense was down, and the Beavers only had 10 out there. And here comes Mendoza back on the field with 35 seconds left.
That's a huge 49-yard pickup.
Caught him sleeping, not sleeping, but just caught him off guard with the run coach.
And a couple missed tackles.
Thede spiked the football with 28.8 seconds left. Slinger wanting just to take some time and make sure they know what they're doing, right?
Well, fans, yep, weren't down.
Fans weren't happy.
And with the spike, it allows Vitense to get back on the field. And now they've got Mendoza and Vitense back out there, the two best pass
rushers. See, I think Cameron's asking, can you spike it out of the shotgun?
You must be able to.
Obviously you can.
I don't know why you want it, but.
Here we go. Burkle's going to stand behind Thede. Now he's going to move to the left, moving to our right, 28.8 seconds, and Burkle's going to motion out. Thede's going to throw, looking for the corner route. Here comes the pressure being flushed. Going to break to the right side. Still got some time. Looking, throws across his body near the goal line. It's incomplete. Looking for Lytle, and Thede did a great job of, you know, holding the ball till somebody came free, and the Beavers will see a third down with 19 seconds left.
Lytle comes up limping a little bit. Boston Damon on the coverage and just sort of kind of falls awkwardly, and Lytle, still in the game, comes back into the huddle.
Third down and 10. But this has been a fun one here today, man.
Yeah,
exciting first half of the playoffs. The winner hosts Germantown next Friday night. Lytle wide to the left. Two wides to the near side. No timeouts for Slinger. Thede has some time. Gets flushed again. If he can bring him down, he's going to chuck it in. It's going to be incomplete. He had the wherewithal. He felt the pressure again from Westover. He knew he couldn't take a sack it in the half.
Here's the problem with the spike is that now it's fourth down for one, but you also had the clock stopped.
Yeah.
You know, so you didn't really need the spike because the clock was stopped because of the official timeout. And now it looks like they're going to come out and kick a field goal.
They're going to attempt a 38-yard field goal. Cole Martin. They've already faked one kick today. Martin from the far hash. It's going to be a 38 yards officially. Good snap. Kick is up. It's a low liner, and that thing's going to sneak through, and it's good. From 38 yards out.
Yeah, I don't know if that ball ever got more than 2 feet above the post, but it was hit so hard that it got over it. That's only his third field goal of the year, but that was pretty important one to get him to 21-17 game.
So we'll keep it here with 9.7 seconds left. He did the job, though, Coach. That's all that matters.
Yeah, I mean, he's certainly more than capable. I've already mentioned him. He's now 39 of 40 in extra points. So you got a guy that can do that. And he's got a leg. The one kickoff went down to the 1 yard line. You know, he's certainly capable of getting that done.
It's 21-17. Now, Coach, Beaver Dam gets the football back with some time on the clock. The way their wide receivers have been getting open, I think you take a shot.
Yeah, I think it's going to depend on where this ball ends up, right? And where does Beaver Dam return it to? But, yeah, I agree. I mean, well, that, you would think Slinger would get out of the one-on-one in that situation.
Martin, I love the old-school kicker. Just let her in. That's a squibber now. I think you going to take a high bounce. Picked up by Freund at the 20, 25. Freund gets fumbles the football with 6.4 seconds left.
And I would bet they'll keep Martin right out there and try another field goal.
That's not what you wanted if you were a Beaver fan, right?
No, and I'm watching Martin right now, and he's still on the bench. 6 seconds left, no timeouts.
They'll just chuck one to the end zone?
Yeah, I think they're just going to chuck it down.
Talk about Slinger with a little momentum right here now, Coach.
Yeah, and that's what you worry about, too, is, you know, is momentum going into halftime, right? Either way this play shakes out. I'm a little surprised. I think I'd send him back out there for the field goal.
You're going to try to run a quick out pattern maybe to get a couple yards, Coach?
But you can't. But they can't. They have to get out of bounds. I mean, they don't have any timeouts left.
Slinger's got four wides, three to the near side, one to the far. Thede's going to throw right side. He's going to chuck it to the end zone.
No.
He got behind him. It's going to be caught into the end zone. Touchdown, Slinger. Disaster for the Golden Beavers. A 31-yard touchdown. The Beavers' defense got caught looking, Coach, and Lytle ran right by him.
Oh, man.
Flat-footed in the secondary.
Yeah, it got beat, and now a 31-yard touchdown pass. It's Slinger's going to go into halftime with all the momentum and a lead.
The extra point is good. We head to the halftime locker room. Somehow Slinger, after being dominated for most of this half, leads 24-21 in this level one Division II playoff game back in 4 minutes on Daily Dodge TV.
This heat has you realizing it's time to upgrade your home's air conditioning. Don't waste another minute or another dollar on wasted energy. Call Surefire today to see how much you could save with a new high-efficiency Lennox air conditioning system. Stay cool and stay calm, knowing Surefire is here for you with 24/7 customer service. Call us at 920-485-4883 or visit us online at surefireinc.com.
The fun doesn't stop when the game clock hits zero. Celebrate your team's sweet victory at the Dump Bar and Grill in Cambria and tackle some mouth-watering appetizers, award-winning juicy burgers, or some crispy wings. The Dump Bar and Grill has it all. And with their newest Annex Edition, enjoy more seating for all fans to gather. Satisfy your hunger and get to the Dump Bar and Grill in Cambria, your go-to spot for great food and good times. TheDumpBar.com, cheering on all our local student-athletes.
Cheer! Now cheer louder! Any accomplishment worth doing is worth doing with all your heart and soul. The entire team at Hometown Glass and Improvement knows that dedication, time, and respect can lead to greatness. When practicing free throws, running for a touchdown, or installing new windows and doors, it's a commitment to something larger than oneself that creates a legacy. So keep cheering for your hometown team. Hometown Glass and Improvement, online at hometownglass.com.
Jerry's Automotive in Beaver Dam is a champion of our local schools. Team up with Jerry's Automotive by pumping your gas at their Spirit Pump, where 2 cents of every gallon is donated to a local school each month. Jerry's Automotive also provides exceptional vehicle service and repairs and a great selection of convenience items. Visit Jerry's Automotive Center, WI.com, and on Facebook. Jerry's Automotive, 700 North Spring Street in Beaver Dam, across the street from Beaver Dam Food Pride.
Is selling your home like a walk in the park? If you are in Central Park at 2 a.m., maybe. Chris Kladowski, Kladowski Real Estate. When it is time to sell, be it due to loss or love, growth or downsizing, staying near or going far, there are three basic steps. List it, sell it, move on. The steps are made simple by working with a trusted real estate advisor. Our family team is with you every step of the way, making those three steps as smooth and fun as possible. Kladowski Real Estate. We look forward to serving you.
At Preferred Dental Partners, our core values are more than just something we put on our wall. They're something we live out. Core value number 3 is compassionate care. Over the years, we've learned a very important anatomy lesson. There are humans attached to the mouths we treat, and we know humans are complex with many needs beyond their teeth. Whether it's the anxiety that accompanies walking into the door of a dental office, or when you're trying to juggle all life is throwing at you, we get it. If you're looking for some compassion with your dental care, call Preferred Dental Partners today.
10% off all brand new 2023 Jeep Grand Cherokees and Compasses during the Jeep Adventure Days event at Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Beaver Dam. Hello, this is Brent Reed, and with savings in excess of $7,000 on select models, there's never been a better time to upgrade your ride. And that's not all. Fall savings are definitely in the air with $10,000 off select Ram Bighorn Crew Cabs while supplies last. Let our family take care of your family at Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Beaver Dam and ReedChrysler.com.
Hi, I'm Josh Schneider with Silica for Your Home. We have a great feature available in our showrooms, our digital price tags. They search the internet every day and allow us to adjust the prices based on our competitors. That ensures you are always getting the best deal. If it finds a lower price, it will automatically change our Silica price in real time. These digital price tags are all about saving you time and money. Shop Silica for Your Home for the best sales, service, and selection.
Time here at Slinger, Coach. The Owls rally late for 10 points in the final, 8 seconds, and they all of a sudden lead Ram 24-21. Shell shock.
Half absolutely dominated by Beaver Dam. I mean, did just bought everything right until the last minute and a half. Cost them 10 points.
Did, and you said they Beaver Dam outgained Slinger, 252 to 216, and I bet you 100 yards of that was in the last 15 seconds of the game.
Yeah, the big 50-yard run right there to then end up setting up the field goal, then the 31-yard touchdown at the end of the half there. Yeah, Beaver Dam 252, Slinger 216 total yardage. Michael Thiede is 7 of 11 for 120 and a touchdown. 6 of those passes have gone to Mark Lytle for 114 yards. He's got the one touchdown catch. And then on the ground, Caleb Burkle, 8 carries for 78 yards. The big 49-yarder at the end of the half was the big one for them. Again, Beaver Dam with 232. Eli Bryant is 10 of 20. He had a stretch here where he completed 5 in a row. He's now incomplete his last 4. 10 of 20, 135, 3 touchdown passes. Kyler Keel, 6 for 86 with a touchdown. Leo George, 1 for 8 with a touchdown. Mendoza, 1 for 9. Jeffrey Freund, 2 for 31 and a touchdown. Josiah Barnes, 10 carries, 86 yards to lead him on the ground.
Here's how the scoring went. Beaver Dam got on the board first in this one as they get going. 109 left in the first. Eli Bryant hit Kyler Keel on a 12-yard touchdown pass. Made it 7-0 with the extra point. Also, then that's how we ended the first quarter. 9:40 in the second, Mike Thiede answered with a 1-yard touchdown run on fourth and goal. The extra point made it 7-7. Beaver Dam answered right back, 7:54 left in the second. Bryant to Leo George, a beautiful pitch and catch. 8 yards, 14-7 Beavers. Went to 21-7 after the Beavers got a squibbed kick. Bryant hit Jeffrey Freund on a 22-yard pass, and the Beavers were rolling. But with 5:02 left, Jack Klippel, an 8-yard touchdown run, 21-14. Beavers felt pretty good, though, because they still had the lead, and they had the ball, and ended up giving it back on a fourth down play because they're kind of in no man's land. And Cole Martin scores on a 38-yard field goal with 9.7 seconds left. Beavers fumble the kickoff, and Mark Lytle catches a 31-yard touchdown pass as time expired. Coach, we think the Beavers only had 10 players on the field.
Yeah, it looked like they might have had 10. Not positive on that, but it looked like we only had 10 players on the field. That's tough because you have that change of possession there with the fumble, the kickoff, and everything else. But, yeah, and if that's the case, I mean, that makes it even worse with the touchdown at the end of the half there.
Beaver Dam football is presented by Hometown Glass and Improvement, Columbus Family Dental, and the Beaver Dam Unified School District. Also brought to you by Cousin Subs of Beaver Dam, American Packaging jumping on board, McKinstry's Home Furnishings, Klidowski Real Estate, Slumberland, Silica for Your Home, Summit Ford, Beaver Dam Tire and Service, Mayville Tire and Service, Surefire, Richards Insurance, Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, the Park Village Shopping Center, Preferred Dental Partners, Jerry's Automotive, Air Care, The Dump, and White Construction. We'll take a look at scores from across the region and the state as halftime rolls on. Slinger 24, Beaver Dam 21, back in 4 minutes on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
Hey, it's Stacy with Slumberland, Beaver Dam in Watertown. Stop in and see everything that our store has to offer. We built it just for you. We have mattresses, box springs, power bases, bedroom sets, furniture, living room sets, dining sets, everything that you would need to complete your entire home. We've got our interest-free financing and a really great local staff here to help you. So you've got all local people here to help you out from start to finish for anything that you would need. So stop in, shop local, and save big with us.
Summit Ford Beaver Dam. We are committed to serving the customers in our community, to bringing you into our dealership, and making the buying process easy, fun, stress-free, and memorable. Thank you for choosing us and voting us Dodge County's best place to buy a new or used vehicle. Stop in today for a test drive and to see how we can help you find the car of your dreams. Summit Ford Beaver Dam.
Are you ready for peace of mind? Chad Guzzi here, owner of Air Care in Beaver Dam. If you're tired of unexpected repair bills, you want to sign up for our Total Care plan. It ensures top performance and prolonged life of your heating and air conditioning equipment. Air Care's Total Care customers receive annual inspections as well as a reduced maintenance rate plus a 10% discount on all service repairs. Air Care, big enough to serve you, small enough to care. 920-356-8860.
Join the American Packaging team and help create packaging for some of the most iconic brands in the world. Sarah says the benefits at American Packaging are fantastic.
At American Packaging, we have a great 401k match. They match us 75 cents for every dollar up to 5%. And we get quarterly bonuses if we meet our budget. We get a Christmas bonus. If you've been here 5 years, you will also get a seniority bonus.
Learn more about joining the American Packaging team in Columbus and DeForest by checking out the careers page at AmericanPackaging.com.
American drivers overpay an average of $368 per year on their auto insurance. Why? Because, well, insurance is hard. It's complicated. It's time-consuming to get quotes from multiple companies, so we overpay. Or we call Richards Insurance in Beaver Dam. Make one call and receive a quote from a great company like Auto Owners Insurance. The team at Richards Insurance will literally do all the work for you. So if you could be saving money each month with an Auto Owners Insurance policy, you'll know about it. How much will you save with Richards Insurance? To find out, call Richards Insurance or stop in at 123 North Spring Street, downtown Beaver Dam. With offices in Columbus, Watertown, West Bend, and Oshkosh. With over 50 employees and hundreds of years insurance experience across 5 offices, you'll get full service counseling with no obligation. Your auto owner's insurance carrier is Richards Insurance in Beaver Dam. Call 887-1615.
We'll be there with you.
Richards Insurance of Beaver Dam.
High school sports are as American as apple pie. And going to a game or meet is a chance to see the stars of tomorrow shine today. But as anybody who's ever attended a high school sporting event in Wisconsin knows, you can't have the stars without the stripes. High schools are currently looking for new officials in almost every sport. Who looks good in stripes? Anybody looking for a way to stay connected to a sport they love. If you like the idea of giving back to your community while earning a few extra bucks, chances are you'd look good in stripes too. We want to hear from you. We need to hear from you. No officials means no games. No stripes means no stars. And what kind of America would that be? Wisconsin needs more high school officials. Go to highschoolofficials.com to sign up or learn more. That's highschoolofficials.com.
Halftime rolls on here at Slinger High School. Wade Bates and Tim Ladderin. 24-21 Beaver Dam Trails. Beaver Dam football presented by Columbus Family Dental. Hometown glass and improvement to the Beaver Dam Unified School. What a hospitality here at Slinger. They offered us food at halftime and concessions, Coach.
It's great.
Hey, great place, great venue, yep. Great atmosphere today.
You said they do it right here, and just beautiful place to play a football game.
What do you got for scores across the region?
Yeah, a couple of interesting scores, whether it's in the region or in the Badger Conference. Sun Prairie East now leads 24-22 over Hartford. Randolph only 22-20 over Krivitz. I think that's a 2-7 game, if I remember right. Right. Howard's Grove 6, Marshall 0, Columbus 35, Broadhead, Judah 0 at half. Stoughton, a 7 or 8. 12-7 lead over Greendale at half. And Wanakee 35-3 over Holman.
Our Mike Pereira, Bruce Kaufman, coach, you asked about the spike off the shotgun.
Yeah.
I guess Coach Kaufman says that that rule changed last year, so the quarterback can spike it out of the shotgun
okay.
to conserve time.
Okay.
So that's what I think what Mendoza was asking on that one play, because down that stretch, I think in the what led to the field goal, they spiked it to kind of stop the clock at one point.
Right.
So those are the scores. If you're Beaver Dam and Coach Brock Lindy, I mean, do you make many changes, Coach? Because you, besides that meltdown you had in the last 30 seconds, you played a pretty good first half.
You did, and I'm going to correct myself, because I think looking on the video, it looks like they had 11 on the field. Just a, you know, just can't let the guy get behind you, right? And so, yeah, I mean, yeah, so first of all, you're upset over the last.
Yes.
There's no question, right? But then you have to take a look at the big picture and say, we still got a half of football. I think if they would have said down 3 at half at Slinger in the playoff game, you would take that. You're in the ball game, and we've talked about all year how good of a fourth quarter team this is. You just got to get to the fourth quarter. They've, outside of that last minute, it's been a dominant football game for Beaver Dam. They figured out a way to move the football through the air, and they've now run it well. Josiah Barnes with over 80 yards on the ground. Defensively, they've been solid. And so I think the thing is now is just, okay, yes, we made the mistakes. Okay, now let's get over it, and let's build on what we did for most of that half and come back out, take that lead, and win this game. Because if they play like they did most of the first half, they can win this football game.
Beaver Dam football presented by Columbus Family Dental, hometown glass and improvement in the Beaver Dam Unified School District. And every month, the Beaver Dam Unified School District recognizes a school of the month, Coach. In the month of October, it's Prairie View Elementary. Brandon Krause, the fine principal over there, does a great job. And I learned from Mark DeStefano on Let's Talk Radio yesterday, I started foreshadowing the November school of the month. And he said, hey, we can't short Prairie View any days. I think Brandon Krause is going to throw some tomatoes into my backyard if at my house. So Prairie View Elementary, the school of the month. And Bruce Kaufman did say that law enforcement – oh, thank you, sir. I appreciate it. That law enforcement came up at the county line of the city limits of Columbus hoping I wasn't going with Tronson and Haldeman because I didn't pick Columbus to win the state championship. So he says that was the case. Next time I'll have the sheriff's watching our broadcast, though, so maybe I'll have him escort me next time I to the county line. We are here at halftime. Beaver Dam 21, or Slinger leads 24-21. Again, the winner is going to host Germantown, who beat Milwaukee King, who put up a better fight. I mean, I'm included. Yeah. I was expecting Germantown, who didn't have a Germantown-like year,
right,
to still go in there and roll Milwaukee King. But,
right,
you know, they were King was up 9-6 at the half.
Yeah, and really, again, Germantown scored a couple scores late in the last 7 minutes of that game. So, yeah, I mean, it's an incredible opportunity for both teams here to not just get a win tonight in round one, but, well, I have an unbelievable shot at home to win a round two game. And this is a big second half for both teams, no question.
It is, and if you're Beaver Dam, you mentioned, you know, they've had cups of coffee in the playoffs. You know, 2011 was the year where they won their first five, and then they blew out their first-round playoff opponent. I think you're correct, it was Hortonville. And then they had an injury. RJ, didn't they have an injury?
RJ Shelton went down in, like, the second play of the game, and just the momentum, you could just feel it just go out of the stadium, and DeForest took full advantage and really dominated that football game.
So here, Beaver Dam will go on defense first to start this half. But again, the pass scheme that Brock Lindy came up here, rolling out Eli Bryant, and the wide receivers have been open all day long. Yep. And let's see if Slinger makes any adjustments as well on their end today, and how they bracket it. And maybe they're going to say, you know, maybe put a little more into the pass defense here today, because, you know, obviously, their run defense was a concern to a lot of people for Beaver Dam, and they talked about it with those big Holsteins up front on both sides. And Beavers held it well because Eli got pressure, but it wasn't like he was, you know, he was shell-shocked and, you know, ducking for cover and chucking ducking at all.
No, you mentioned the schemes are great because using Eli's athletic ability and rolling him out and getting him out of that traffic has allowed more time and those receivers who could mention who could fly time to get open downfield. You're right, Wade. I think the big thing this half is what does Slinger do on the defensive side? Because if Slinger doesn't change on the defensive side, I think Beaver Dam's gonna come out scoring again. And then I think it's all in Beaver Dam's side of it. If Slinger comes out and makes adjustment, then what does Beaver Dam do to kind of adjust to that? Again, Josiah Barnes has gotten a couple big runs. He's at 10 carries for 86 yards, so been able to run it a little bit. But I think if you're Slinger, you think you'd rather see that than what the guys running open downfield all night have been.
Just look at the body language of Slinger right now, coach, as they warm up compared to where they were with about, let's just say, maybe 5 minutes left in the first half.
Yeah. Yeah, well, they called that timeout, got everybody together, and the coaches got after him, and there were some mistakes all over the place, and Beaver Dam was getting some breaks and was taking advantage of them. Yeah, the momentum shifted for sure.
And that's maybe what Coach Lindy's doing to his squad right now, Coach, has them gathered right around the 25-yard line.
Yeah, there's no question. I mean, this is what's great about playoff football. Yeah. Everything's on the line, right? And you get a 4-5 matchup where two teams that are really good teams that are pretty equal going after each other. It makes it a lot of fun, and all this momentum shifts have been something to watch. I think we're only one half through it.
Who's doing the talking in the middle there? Because I see Coach Lindy out by the 40-yard line.
I think it's it might have been Gabe Klatt in the middle there. I thought I saw Eric, the trainer, in there. Not sure which one it was, but
Richard in there
might have been Richard in there. Yeah, Lauterbach's out there as well. You know, here's the thing too. The kid, this is one of those things that it's more of, hey, don't get down on yourself. No. Let's go, get over it. It's not going to be a lack of energy because everybody knows it's a playoff game. Got to come out big stop here to start the half.
Coach, I think my board, I have a board that's got all my information. does it have four more games in it here this year?
Bruce Kaufman just messaged us and said that Colton Brunell just scored to make it 42-0 for Columbus. He now has 5 yards to tie and 6 to break the all-time rushing record in the state. That's unbelievable.
He's just been a beast, you know, and Columbus looking to win back-to-back titles. Beavers will kick off. Cameron Mendoza is going to kick off. It looks like we have Lytle over to the left. Beavers have decided they're not going to kick it to those guys. They're playing way up now again. They made that adjustment already.
Yep. Now they're going to adjust and bring another guy. They go 5-4 up front instead of 6-3.
They have a great soundtrack here as well at Slinger, Coach.
Yeah, they do.
I approve of the playlist. Mendoza going to kick off going right to left. And he's going to squib it again, and it's going to be it's still loose on the ground. It's going to be bobbled again. It's going to be picked up over there by Hendricks, and he got hammered by Brock Mullenbach.
Yeah, Brock laid the wood there. That was a big hit. And, again, it's going to be plays like that for the defense here that's going to get this momentum back shifted. The big thing is can't let a score here.
Big series here because Slinger's got all the momentum, leading 24-21, 10 points in the final 9 seconds of the half. Wide to the left. Micknick. To the near side, it's Lytle. Thede. Hand off Burkle up the middle, and he's going to weave right through his off. Look at that. He just got up there across the 30 to the 31, and then coming up and making the tackle was Moose Morrissey. Nice gain on first down for the Owls. Hey, if you got us on the big screen somewhere, you can. If you're watching on your device, you can go to Daily Dodge TV on YouTube and watch on your television. If you are watching on a TV, send us an email, sports@dailydodge.com. Take a picture of the big screen, or if you're watching with the campfire tonight. A little chilly for a campfire or not yet?
Oh, no. Beautiful night tonight.
Second down and 4 from the 34. Hand off to Burkle again up the middle, and he is going to get right behind that line up to the 39, maybe the 40, and that'll move the chains for the Owls. Sports@dailydodge.com. Just put Beaver Dam or Slinger in the headline, and we have an injured Golden Beaver. Came out from the bottom of that pile right there. Looks like cramp, maybe. Getting too cold for cramps, isn't it, Coach?
Yeah. I don't know what we got, but it looks like a
I don't know who that is, so we're not gonna.
But that offensive line they put. So on first down, you know, they've got Garrick, the big 6'3", 340, on the right tackle, and then at right next to him is Hoytnick, the 6'4", 305 junior that's going to Stanford. They run right behind him. The second play, they pull the big tackle out there, and he's got good feet. He turned the corner, made a nice block.
Coach Tim White is giving a bunch of okay, well, I'll try to decipher this email from Tim White, Coach. I can't know if I can. He left me War and Peace here on an email. I honestly didn't think he could type. Right side, handoff to Burkel. Fumble! Football, it's loose, and he covered it up at the 48. I'm assuming this is for us, isn't it? Tim, try to decipher that for me. We should just maybe take a screenshot of the email, right? Coach White, I thought he was going to get on me about those yellow pants the Beavers are wearing. Back to the line of scrimmage. It's second down and two from the 48-yard line. Thede, shotgun right side. It's going to be caught. Nearly picked off. Beeb Mullenbach, I think, had it. We're going to get a flag late. Thede ended up catching.
It's only going to be a 5-yard pickup.
That's going to cost him 15 probably, though.
To Lytle. Yeah, and I think it's going to be.
That was Mullenbach over there that had the pick, wasn't he? He just slipped through his hands?
Yep, Mullenbach had it.
And then Lytle caught it, and then they're going to call personal foul, head contact. And that'll be 15 yards added to the catch.
Brock made a great read on that. He just missed it. He made a great read.
It was a 15-yard penalty from the end of the run.
So Slinger on the move with 10-10 left here in the third quarter. 24-21.
All right. Come on, let's get some. We need a play here. Any sort of little momentum driver here.
Burkle stands to the left of Thede. Couple of wide receivers to the near side. Lytle's on the outside. Missed the handoff. Fumble the football again. Burkle covered it up, Coach.
Yeah, it was Mullenbach who knocked it out of there.
Gain of a couple, maybe two. Second down and eight with 9:41 left here in the third quarter.
That right side of that line, like I think I'd spend 90% of my plays just running behind those horses.
Micknick and Lytle wide to the left. Hand off to up the middle, Klipple again, and he's going to get maybe the 25. Allen's in Ladysmith watching at their cabin. CJ Hogg plays for the Slinger Owls. Go Owls. Thanks for the email, Allen.
Nice tackle by Aiden Root, diving in at the feet of Klipple.
Lytle wide to the left. Micknick to the near side, along with Lucas Sun. Going to motion Micknick right to left. They're going to hand it off to Micknick, and he's going to get the corner. Gets a block on the outside by Klipple, and he's going to get the first down, and then he'll get out of bounds inside the 25-yard line. 24-21 Slinger here in the third quarter. This playoff opener. I was going to say short.
Oh, wow.
More than less than one at the 21.
Wow. Boy, certainly looked like he had it. That's the far side, though. And all right, fourth and short. Let's get a stop.
Fourth down in inches. Thede's going to work out of the shotgun. He's going to keep it himself, and he's going to break to the outside. Oh. I don't think he got it. Let's wait and see. It was Prewee, and he didn't. I thought he was going to point the other way. They're going to move the chains.
First down. Oh, man, that was close. Prewee and Root right there making a play.
Got an email as well. Somebody watching at work. Thanks for the broadcast. Got called into work and has to miss my nephew DeRuyter's game tonight. That came from Corey. Appreciate the Slinger fans watching. Been fun watching your squad play tonight. Here's Thede out of the shotgun again. Hands off right side. And is that Klippel?
Jack Klippel.
Yep.
The ball
carrier. It's Westover and Morrissey on the tackle.
8 minutes left in the third quarter. 24-21 Slinger leads with the hammer here. Impressive drive to start the third quarter. Son and Mikanik wide to the left of the near. Lytle's in single coverage on the near side, coach. Handoff up the middle again to Klippel, and he is going to race to the 10-yard line, and that's going to move the chains. It's going to be first and goal for the Owls with 7:37 left.
I tell you what, I hate to, I kind of hate to say this because Lytle's been so good tonight, but I'd kind of like to see him throw it because, I mean, Slinger's done a nice job of just pounding this ball up the middle and using those big offensive linemen. It'd be the 10th play of the drive.
I always say getting a double-digit drive in high school football without making a mistake, whether it be a holding penalty that kills a drive or turning it over, is really hard. And so far, Slinger has been flawless here as they have a first and goal from the 10. Thede again. Klippel stands to his right. Play fake. He's going to keep it himself. He's got some room, and he is going to get ripped down at the 5-yard line. It'll be second down and goal.
Tackle by Deals. A 5-yard pickup.
Brandon Morrissey on the stop.
Morrissey was in there as well. That was Deals, wasn't it?
I think it was Deals, yeah. It's not, the 6 and the 8 are hard.
I can't. Yeah. You'd find me $20 every time I guessed. Tim, you'd be going to the Slinger house tonight for supper on me. But I can't pay off bets because I still own – I'm 11 months out on a bet I own Ninja at the Bayside Supper Club. And he knows I'm good for it someday. Power to the right side. They're going to bring big number 99, Lockstead, in the backfield. He's going to lead the way. They're going to hand it off her right side near the goal line. He tried to pick up and pull his running back across the goal line. Klippel, did you see that?
Yeah.
He grabbed onto him and tried to pull him forward.
But it's going to be only a pickup of – no, pick up a 3.
What, third and goal?
Yep.
6:05 left in the half.
Taking up
in the third.
Half the quarter.
Third and goal from the 2. Klippel stands to the right of Thede. Power to the right. Thede's going to keep it himself, and he is going to turn the corner. He gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Owls.
Well, Slinger does a good job of turning all that momentum in the end of the first half into a long, sustained drive. That was an impressive drive by Slinger.
Yardage and play number, coach, have you added that up yet?
Working on it.
Come on.
12 for 73.
The extra point is up, and it is good. 5:48 left in the third quarter. Slinger 31, Beaver Dam 21 on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
Hi, this is Sandy from McKinstry's Home Furnishings in downtown Beaver Dam. We are proud to support all Beaver Dam athletes. While at home watching high school sports, why not be comfortable? McKinstry's is a Lazy Boy comfort studio. We have sofas, recliners, sectionals, and reclining sofas. Stop into McKinstry's Home Furnishings in downtown Beaver Dam and add comfort to your home.
Join the American Packaging team and help create packaging for some of the most iconic brands in the world. Sarah says the benefits at American Packaging are fantastic.
At American Packaging, we have a great 401k match. They match us 75 cents for every dollar up to 5%. And we get quarterly bonuses if we meet our budget. We get a Christmas bonus. If you've been here 5 years, you will also get a seniority bonus.
Learn more about joining the American Packaging team in Columbus and DeForest by checking out the careers page at AmericanPackaging.com.
Here's the kickoff, and it's going to go into the end zone for the touchback, and the Beavers will start first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Maybe the biggest drive of the season right now, coach, for BD.
Yeah, and you know, they've got experience at this.
Yes.
To use here now that they've really done a good job of putting drives together this year when they've needed them. And you're right. This is probably the biggest one of the year right now.
You led 21-14 with late in the first half. Single wide receivers to each side. Bryant going to hand off to Josiah Barnes. He's going to slide through the line. He's going to push his way to the 25 and fall forward to the 26. A tackle again made by Retzloff.
Nice. Give it 5-6. 6 on the pickup for Josiah.
John Sharkey.
Second and 4 at the 26.
Beaver's got to drop the hammer here on the Slinger defense. Bryant going to roll to his right. Check to the near side. Now he's going to look. He's going to heave it long up for grabs. It's duck hunting season, coach. If somebody had a 12-gauge right there, they probably would have took a shot. That thing slipped out of Eli's hands, I think.
Yeah, I think so. He got hit as he threw it. He had Kyler Keel open short, it looked like.
That's what they were looking for on the near side, and then he came back. Third down and about, we're going to call it
third
6?
Down and 4.
Third and 4, a long 4. Mendoza wide to the near side along with Freund. 4 wide for the Golden Beavers. Here's Bryant. Screen on the right side. It's going to be incomplete as he threw it behind Leo George, and the Beavers didn't need a 3 and out right there. No. 5:04 left after the defense was out there for
a long time.
A long time, like 6.
6 minutes, a little over 6.
And then they're back out on the field about 40 seconds later.
I don't need a good punt from Jeffrey here.
Lytle is...
Beaver Dam doesn't have enough guys on the field.
Freund, wait. Snap is decent. Here comes the pressure. Got partially blocked. Beaver Dam got a decent bounce, though.
Great
got a
bounce.
Huge bounce across the 40 down to the 35. It's still rolling. Look at that thing inside the 20 to the 28-yard line. And, boy, you made lemonade out of lemons right there.
Yeah, it ends up being a great punt. Yeah, I think the guys are trying to wave it and keep going. All right. Big break after the partial block. And Slinger does not have great field position on the 28.
Hey, Brett Recheck checks into the broadcast. Brett and Jody, Jake and Nick, enjoying the broadcast from their living room, saying go Beavers. Thanks to the sponsors for making this possible.
We had TC00610 say, go Beavers, a great job announcing where we can actually see the numbers tonight.
You know, I felt bad.
Yeah, go ahead.
You know, we'll hold on. Thede's going to work out of the shotgun. Hand off to Burkle, and he's going to get the 30 to the 31, and that's it. So we could not see the numbers. That was against Oregon, right?
Yeah.
And then Ninja said something about they look great on the camera.
Yeah.
And so I went back and watched, and you could see the numbers clear as day.
Yeah.
But we could not see them on the field, could we?
No, we couldn't see it at all. And I know you, like.
I texted you the next
day.
You
texted me, and I went and looked, too, and I'm like, are you kidding me? Like, you can see it perfect on camera.
People listening must have been, or watching on Daily Dodge TV, must have been like, these guys are just old. Are they blind or what?
It's like Big T is down. Looks like with a cramp.
It'd take two people to stretch that out.
Yeah.
Big T was the white construction athlete of the week a couple weeks back.
Big T's had a really, really nice season for the Golden Beavers. In Wanakee last week, he had a pass deflected.
Yes.
they had set up a screen, and Big T had kind of read it. And he went up and went with the receiver for a little bit and put his big paw up there and got it knocked away.
Howard's Grove leads Marshall 14-0. Now, Marshall and Matt Kleinhines' squad, all three of his captains had been hurt at the end of the year.
Ugh.
You know, they were a team that had been rolling. You know, they lost. They had run the table the first 3 years of the Eastern Suburban, never lost a game, dropped one this year with some injuries, and then shared the conference championship with Horicon Eustis Ford. Trying to get a Houston score again. Let's see if our friend Bruce Brandenburg is at one of those games. If anybody's got a Horicon Houston score, let us know.
Big T getting up, walking off, getting a nice ovation from this crowd.
Houston leads Oostburg 35-7.
Hartford is taking the lead over Sun Prairie East. Again, that's the two seed in this bracket. Sun Prairie East at 28-24 Hartford lead. Could have the 8 and the 7 win in the first round of this bracket.
Couple of wide receivers to the far side. 4:38 left in the third. 31-21. Slinger leads Beaver Dam. It scored 17 straight. Handoff to Burkle, and he goes down. It's going to be third down.
Burkle now at 13 carries for 99 yards.
Good to have one of our newest teammates, Corey Sparks, checking into the broadcast. He broadcast the game last week.
Third and five at the 34.
You'll be hearing a lot of him during your season, Coach. We're going to make an effort to do all the Beaver Dam boys and girls games this season. So,
love it.
A couple of crews. He and Charlie Dern, of course, Mike Tronson will have the game as well. Thede, out of the shotgun, going to throw. He's got some time. Here comes the pressure. Fires it, and Lytle makes the catch, sliding down at the Slinger 46-yard line, and that'll move the chains.
Lytle has just been so impressive tonight. 8 catches for 131.
At the 46-yard line.
He's like Cooper Kupp. He's always open. Keep throwing him the ball.
First and 10 for Slinger, who's just going to continue to dominate time of possession in this quarter. Beavers have had it for about 45 seconds, and that's it. Thede again, and they're milking the clock right now, up 10. Hand off to Klippel, and he's going to run right into Morrissey, and he'll gain a couple. Beavers just need a turnover or something again and get a little spark, because it's exactly the opposite, Coach, of the first half. You know, Slinger had the body language that I'm seeing in Beaver Dam right now.
Yep. No, you're right. And it does. It's hard when things are going this way to stay up, and you keep, you know, as a coach, come on, let's go, stay up. It really does take a play from somebody to get everybody back on the same page and going.
Wide receivers to each side, second down and 7 from their own 48. Slinger moving left to right on your ESPN dial. Play fake. Here comes the pressure. Oh, and he's going to slip by Mullenbach. Thede still going. He's breaking to the outside, looking. Going to fire across to Lytle, who's going to make the catch across the 40 down to the 39. One of those cases where Brock Mullenbach an inch away from pulling down Thede, and he got away, and Lytle just gets open. I mean, you just tip your cap to Lytle there, because he's so good.
Well, and does a nice job of you know, finding a spot for his quarterback as he's running out of trouble. Again, he avoids two tacklers, Thede does, and then looks upfield, and he's got his guy for his ninth catch of the night.
2:15 and counting here in the third quarter. 31-21 Slinger with the hammer and the lead. Thede, handoff right side again. There's Burkle again working through that. Now that offensive line starting to heat up a little bit, Coach.
Yeah, and, you know, when you have that one long drive to start the half, and now you're starting to put another one together, and those big, strong bodies are starting to lean on that defensive line a little bit more, and makes it tougher and tougher.
Slinger's going to salt away this entire quarter. 3 plays for Beaver Dam in this third quarter. That's it. Thede will have Klippel to his right. Going to chuck it to the end zone, looking for Lytle. Sweeney's right there, and did Lytle make the catch?
No.
They're going to say it's incomplete. Sweeney on the coverage. Lytle showed some ups there as well to battle Sweeney for that football.
He had Mikanik wide open on the post route, but, I mean, Lytle's been so hot, you don't –
He's throwing up there expecting to catch it.
One-on-one coverage deep. You don't question that at all, the way he's been playing tonight.
Couple of wide receivers to the far side. Third down, we'll call it 4. Handoff right side to Klippel again. He's going to move the chains down near the 27-yard line. Slinger is just taking command of this football game.
Yeah, even when you get, you know, in that situation, you get a 3rd and 4, and you just hope you hold them to 1 or 2, and they're very comfortable pounding it up the middle and picking up 6, because that line has been is just, as you mentioned, Wade, just taking over the game. And now this, again, we're looking at another double-digit drive. This will be number 9 for them.
First and 10. Low snap, had movement. So, hey, Tim, I'm trying to get emails and texts from Dawn Carroll's friends saying, just so you know, Dawn's sitting on that side because she's got high school friends whose son plays for Slinger. She says the kid, they like their family. And I guess we are well aware of that, Tammy Jelka. Just letting you know, we're well aware, Tammy.
Yeah, that's great.
I bet you Tony Carroll's on the other side. Right? He's probably sitting on the Beaver Dam side. 2:25 seconds left in the third quarter. It's going to be first and 15 for the Owls from the 32-yard line. Motioning Sun left to right. And Thede's going to step up to throw. Now he's going to run, and he's going to break a tackle and break another tackle down inside the 25, and that's going to run out the third quarter. Slinger had the football for all but about 42 seconds in the third quarter. We head to the fourth. 31-21 Owls on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN back in 60 seconds.
Jerry's Automotive in Beaver Dam is a champion of our local schools. Team up with Jerry's Automotive by pumping your gas at their Spirit Pump, where 2 cents of every gallon is donated to a local school each month. Jerry's Automotive also provides exceptional vehicle service and repairs and a great selection of convenience items. Visit Jerry's Automotive Center, WI.com, and on Facebook. Jerry's Automotive, 700 North Spring Street in Beaver Dam, across the street from Beaver Dam Food Pride.
Is selling your home like a walk in the park? If you were in Central Park at 2 a.m., maybe. Chris Kladowski, Kladowski Real Estate. When it is time to sell, be it due to loss or love, growth or downsizing, staying near or going far, there are 3 basic steps. List it, sell it, move on. The steps are made simple by working with a trusted real estate advisor. Our family team is with you every step of the way, making those 3 steps as smooth and fun as possible. Kladowski Real Estate. We look forward to serving you.
Into the fourth quarter, 31-21. Slinger looking to really take command of this, or they can punch it in, Coach.
11th play of the drive.
Had a 12-play drive, now an 11-play drive. Thede, and they're going to hand it off again. Burkle, and he gets pulled down by Mendoza. It'll be 3rd and long.
Okay, now here's the play, right? This is 3rd and 8. Have to have this stop. 3rd and 8. Have to have it.
Columbus now up 49-0. They'll be heading to Prairie du Chien's, comfortably up on top of theirs. Their game. Sun wide to the right, 3rd and 8. A couple of wide receivers to the near side, the short side of the field as the Owls moving to the left, and Slinger's going to pop a timeout. We'll keep it right here.
Timeout taken by the Owls.
Football Friday night is coming up. Going to join that in progress. The way this thing's going. Wade Bates and Tim Ladron. Coming up tomorrow night, a couple of things on the family of networks tomorrow. We'll have Badger football 12:30 against Illinois on 95.3 WBEV. The National League Championship Series Game 5 tomorrow night at 6:30 on 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam. Sunday, 11 o'clock on ESPN Beaver Dam, Detroit and Baltimore. NFL action, Packers and Denver on WBEV. By the way, the Beaver Dam Girls Basketball Fundraiser Party is at Park Avenue starting at 2 o'clock on Sunday. If you want to get out there, there's lots of things going on, Coach. Right? They do a lot of things for the program on that event.
Yeah, I watch a little Packer game, a little raffle, and a lot of other stuff. It's always great to get out and support them as well. And so, yeah, if you can get out there, that'd be great.
3rd down and 8 from the Beaver Dam 25-yard line. Slinger with a 10-point lead. Suns wide to the right. 2 wide receivers to the near side. Thede, long snap. Here comes the throw up over the middle, and it's going to be caught. Ooh, did he catch it? They're going to talk about it. Did Micknick, did he make the catch?
There They're going to give it to him.
There's a bobble in there, but it'll be fourth down.
Westover is pretty confident in saying that's not a catch.
And there's a flag on the play anyway.
Well, the official in the middle of the field had to duck out of the way of the pass, and so he couldn't turn and see whether it was complete or not. The side judges couldn't see it, but it's getting backed up anyway.
Get a hold. They're going to wind the clock here with 11:18 left in regulation.
Third and 18 at the 35.
Slingers had all the momentum, scored, 10 points in the final 10 seconds of the half. Third down and 18 from the 35-yard line of Beaver Dam. Thede going to throw. Here comes the pressure from Vitez. Steps up, looking, heaves it the other way, and it's going to be caught at the 20-yard line, pushed out of bounds. It's going to be shy of the first down. It'll be fourth down with the clock stopping at 10:48. They completed that pass over there to Braden Schnorenberg. So it's fourth and three at the 20. They got to get down to the 17-yard line, Coach, to move the chains.
Yeah, and again, if Beaver Dam has any, thoughts of still winning this football game, this is a stop we probably have to have right now.
Fourth down and three. Thede going to keep it himself, and he's going to break to the outside. Oh, he broke a tackle. He's going to turn the corner. He's got the first down to the 10, to the 5, to the end zone. Touchdown, Slinger.
Ran behind that right side, that big offensive line, and then it was one broken tackle for Thede, and he was gone the rest of the way.
And that right there puts the Beavers in a huge hole with 10:40 left.
Well, and remember, Beaver Dam was up 21-7 at one point. It is now 30. That's a 31-0 run for Slinger.
The score, your alls 38, Golden Beavers 21.
He caps a 15-play drive. That goes 72 yards.
Another long drive.
Six 609.
What was the number on that drive again?
15 plays, 72 yards. 609 off the clock. Their two drives have taken over 12 minutes. Their two drives in the second half. Their area score, Houstonford Horicon advances 42-21.
10:40 left here.
Kicking off for the Owls, number 50, Cole Martin.
Sorry, 49-21.
Jason Fiacco's team has brought that Texas flavor to Houstonicon. Freund's going to catch it in the end zone. He's going to bring it out. Jeffrey to the 10, to the 15, and he gets rocked at about just before he got to the 15, actually. That's where the Beavers going to start, first and 10 with 10:36 left here in the half. So Beavers have only had it for how many plays in this second half?
Three. Three plays in the half compared to 27 for Slinger. Thinking Jeffrey would have probably a better opportunity there to maybe let that one go, take that thing at the 20. But you can't. It's hard to blame a kid that's trying to make a play when all the momentum's on the other side of the field.
First and 10 at the 14.
Beavers will have it. Mendoza, power to the left. Bryant's going to throw. Going to chuck and duck, looking for Leo George, and it's going to be knocked away on the far side of the field. Deflected away by Caleb Burkle. At least second down and 10.
Second down and 10.
Slinger's secondary has done a much better job here in the second half, taking away some of the deep balls.
My wife Crystal checks in from Lake Geneva tonight. Got a girls' weekend.
Nice. Lake Geneva's a nice place to be.
Staying at some resort down there. A couple of wide receivers to each side, second down and 10. Gonna motion Keel. Play fake. Bryant's going to throw. Looking. Gets across his body. He's got Leo George, or it's the Freund all by himself, and he dropped it. Jeffrey Freund dropped it. That's the same play they ran early in the game. There's a flag on the play, though.
Eli Bryant got pounded by two guys. Did a nice job of staying in there. Threw a really, really nice ball.
Going to be on the Beavers anyway. I think that Kyler turn up field a little bit early on the motion.
Ineligible.
Well, called ineligible. Okay. Going to be declined. It's going to be third and 10.
I mean, when you consider that pass rush and what he with two guys bearing down on him and rolling right, throwing left all the way across the field, that's a really impressive throw by Eli.
Brenner Rhodes and Emerson Damon checking in from Minnesota playing hockey tonight. They say go Beavers. Jamie Rhodes checking in as well. Three wide for Beaver Dam, third and 10. Bryant working out of the shotgun. Going to throw. Heaves it a little bit high. And, boy, the official on that side reached for the flag as they were looking for Keel and then thought otherwise.
He thought about it. And that's going to bring up.
Coach Lindy's going to send the punting unit out. Six plays and two punts in the second half for the Golden Beavers.
Yeah, it's been tough sledding. It's, there's been, a couple. Pass rush has been tough. It's just been a rough go in these two drives here. And Slinger's absolutely dominated the second half.
Freund gets a good kick, taking Lytle all the way back to the 44-yard line, going to reverse field. He's going to spin through one tackle, got popped again. And Slinger's going to start first and 10 at the Beaver Dam 47-yard line with a 38-21 lead. Is there a flag on the play?
It is. Legal shift?
Going to decline, and Slinger will just take it. Can appreciate the hospitality of everyone here at Slinger. Very friendly and helping us get ready for the game, the athletic department.
First and 10, Owls at the 40.
Always friendly coming to see. We don't get here very often, Coach.
No, we don't.
You've seen him in the postseason a few times, though, haven't you?
Yeah.
For basketball?
We've seen him a few times. We like playing them. It's a good program. Well coached.
10:06 left. It's 38-21. Hand off up the middle again, and that's Klipple. And he's still on his feet across the 40 to the 39. Gain of about 8.
Carries for 108. Oh, I'm sorry, that was Klipple. My fault. 10 carries for 53 for Klipple.
Slinger, with the way things are falling, the Slinger team might be the favorite in this quad here now, Coach.
Well, I was just thinking about that because the 8 seed advance over the 1. If some Prairie East win or falls to Hartford, Slinger's already beaten Hartford. That's the 7 seed. Nicolet's the 3.
Nicolet beat Slinger, though, correct? Yes. Now Klipple on the right side. Flags everywhere here.
Jack Klipple on the carry.
Tackle for the Golden Beavers was made by Parker Stotts.
Be a hold on Slinger.
9:17 left in this one. It's 38-21.
I mean, but to your point, Wade, yeah, you got to think, like, feeling pretty good going, these next couple weeks.
Holding
with the way that the bracket might be falling here.
Second and 13.
9:14 and counting. Thede again taking his time. Hand off again. Oh, he kept it himself. A nice fake. They're going to turn the corner, and he's going to turn upfield. He's going to stay down, and he went down awkwardly on the near side when he was tackled by Morrissey. And smart decision there to keep it in bounds.
Smart decision, but you could imagine the coach thinking, oh, no.
Because he kind of put the brakes on. Yeah. He didn't like actually slide. He kind of stayed up, and then Morrissey hit him, and he kind of twisted awkwardly.
Final score in Marshall. Howard's Grove ends up winning that game 14-6.
Wow. Couple of wides to the far side with 8.5 left in this one, 38-21. 31 straight points for the Owls. Thede's going to throw right side, looking for the knockout punch to Lytle. He's going to make the catch at the 20-yard line.
I mean, it's a great, well defended by A.J. Sweeney. It's just a better play by Slinger. It's a 24-yard pickup.
You know, we've seen teams dominate the first half in time of possession a couple times this year, you know, where the Beavers only had a few plays.
Right.
This has kind of been reversed here with 8 minutes left.
You just wonder what the momentum of the game would have been without that last 30 seconds of the first half.
Thede again. Hand off to Burkle. Going to break another tackle. Gets to the 20. Beaver defense still hitting hard. That was Westover again.
Yep.
Another cramp for, looks like when another Beaver is down.
Jared Westover with the tackle. Injury timeout on the
Prewee, field. Maybe.
With 7:33 left.
Krivitz leading 33-28 with the ball with 5 minutes left against Randall.
Wow.
I mean, you get to the playoffs, you know, they always say anything can happen. But typically, you don't, in the football world, you don't see a ton of huge upsets in the early rounds, but there's been a few tonight and could be a couple more. That is Avery Prewee.
He's okay.
I mean, what a year that kid's had defensively for Beaver Dam, and it's really – has been one of the guys that has really stepped up on that defense in the loss of Gabe Klatt. You start mentioning him more and more in the plays he's making the second half of the season.
So everybody's okay. Looks like hopefully he's going to be okay. Thede. Going to hand off to Burkle again to the outside, and he is going to get down to the 12.
You know, he started taking that left and then cut back right, and that, again, that right side of that offensive line is just a bulldozer, and he gets all kinds of room on that side. Picks up 7. 18 carries for 116.
32.
Again, Slinger comfortably on top. They look like they're going to advance to host Germantown. Thede, he's going to get pulled down by Mendoza. Going to be short of the first down.
Nice play by Mendoza there.
Clock winds below 6.5 minutes left, 38-21.
And Slinger's doing it, taking their time here. 17-point lead.
4th and 2 at the 14.
They're going to let this run and take a timeout.
6-10 and counting. Good year regardless, Coach. Beaver Dam really took a step forward this year, didn't they? Obviously, they worked through adversity. You know, you can't not talk about the injury to Gabe Klatt.
Yeah.
But they persevered, and the coaching staff found ways to kind of rework their offense a little bit. Josiah Barnes, you know, stepped up as that main tailback position. And, you know, the fact that you've seen, you know, them evolve their offense a little bit, the grittiness that we talked about, adversity. How many times this year do they have to get a big drive to go tie the game or put the game away? I mean, they have to hang their heads high. You know, this is another – this senior class, as we talked, you know, is kind of the first group – that's gone all 4 years under the weight program and such, and they've set the table. I mean, there's a lot of talent coming up behind them now, right, that have bought into the system?
Yeah, they really have. And you're right. There's two sides to this. There's the one that you're always going to go, man, what if, right? But then there's on the other side of seeing all these guys that – and it's different guys that you can – you know, on both sides of the ball that have completely just stepped up. And there's a lot of juniors on this team with a lot of guys coming back. And you've got a lower level program where the JV and JV twos both went 7-2, so you've got a lot of promise moving into next year. into a new conference.
A new league next year with they're going to move into the East Central next year with Port Washington, Plymouth, Watertown staying with them, which is a good thing, Kettle Moraine Lutheran, Keewaskum. A lot of new teams to figure out. It'll be fourth down and four from the 14-yard line. Clipple stands to the right of Thede. Thede going to roll to his right, going to come back to the near side. They're going to go to the end zone. It's going to be broken up on the play by Boston Damon. The Beavers will take possession with 5:52 left.
And that's one of the things, like, it's obviously been a rough second half, but you love the fact that the kid, you know, 6 minutes left, down 17, still coming out here making plays. Cameron Mendoza makes a big play behind the line of scrimmage there. Boston Damon gets the big deflection. The defense still standing up tall and doing what they can. You know, you got to be really, really pleased with the effort of the guys.
So the Beavers will hustle out there. If you're a fan of the Beavers, you have to be proud of what you saw here this season. Bryant going to throw the screen to Freund, who made the catch. And that's when, see, again, that's a catcher. Jeffrey could have alligator armed that because the throw was over the middle in front of him. But he did. He made the catch and moved the chains.
A nice pass and a really nice catch. Picks up 14.
Beaver's going to get right back to the line of scrimmage, moving to our right, trailing 38-21. And we had movement, I believe, a little bit early for the goal. I'm going to say Slinger jumped off sides. We lined up offsides. That'll give him a free 5 yards.
Yeah, and the other thing, too, I think, is coming out here. We talked about it the first half, obviously, when things are going well. But coming out here in a pretty hostile environment, you had the whole thing early on, before the game, whatever. But a nice punch in the mouth right away to get going. And coming out here not afraid to make plays. And just, you know, obviously it steamrolled at the end here. But you got to be really proud of the way they came out of here.
Bryant out of the shotgun, hand off to Barnes on the left side. Josiah's going to break to the outside, 40, 45, 50. Josiah Barnes got submarined at the Slinger 45-yard line. That'll move the chains.
Pick up a 22 for Josiah. 12 carries for 114.
Beavers racing to the line of scrimmage with under 5 minutes left.
It's like Slinger's got a lot of their seconds in there.
Down 38-21. Bryant's going to throw again, looking. He's going to chuck it long, looking for Leo George, and he just couldn't get there.
Boy, Eli got popped on that one as well. It was 74, Cooper Williams, a 6'1", 230 junior. And laid the hit on Eli there.
Scores and highlights from across the state of Wisconsin on 1430 ESPN tonight. If you're watching on Daily Dodge TV, you can also stream it at DailyDodge.com. If you click on ESPN 1430. Chuck Freeman, good friend of both of ours, and Dan Pfeiffer will get reports from all across the state. Bryant to Keel, who's going to make the catch, give up some ground, and trying to turn forward. Kyler breaks a tackle. He's going to still work hard, and he's going to get pulled down at the 38-yard line. And a
little extra.
Yeah, a little extra there.
Little extra hit there by James Constantino. Gave him a little bit extra there. They are a physical bunch.
Bryant's, here comes the pressure. Bryant's going to chuck it to the corner again. Keel, and that's going to be intercepted and dropped over there. On the coverage was Weston Fogle. 4:21 left.
And, you know, that's what they got to do. They just kind of keep taking shots deep, try to catch a big one. Down three scores.
And we'll get a timeout on the field, an injury timeout. I think they're going to go make sure that Weston's okay over there.
It's an official timeout.
Yeah, I think they're going
to. They pulled them over to the Beaver Dam side. Is that what they did there? And now the trainers are going to go over there? Or maybe Beaver Dam needed a trainer.
Maybe Beaver Dam needed a trainer over there. Okay, that's what it is, because Fogle's okay. Fourth down and a couple for the Beavers. Bryant's going to throw. Chuck it to the right side, and he just throws it out of bounds. He took another hit.
Yeah, he's getting hit on everyone now.
And that'll turn it over on downs.
Result of the play is a turnover on downs. First and 10, Owls.
And that's, I mean, again, Nick said, Wade, a really nice effort tonight. And certainly didn't see any quit out of us, and that's a great sign. And it, you know, for a program that's on the rise, a really nice year. And you know, you hate to say it, stepping stone, because maybe it diminishes what they did, but it's a really good sign for the program getting here.
Colton Brunell did break the all-time rushing record tonight for Columbus in their victory. Handoff on the right side, and that's going to be handoff again to Klippel again. With 4 minutes left.
No gain on the play.
No gain on the play. So congratulations to Colton Brunell.
Yeah, that's unbelievable.
Beavers led in this one. If I go back, it was 21-7 with I'll get the official numbers for you. We'll talk about it in the post-game show as well. But they led 21-7 in this one in the first half. Low snap, and it's going to be picked up and run up across the 45 by Thede.
I'm a little surprised that he's still in the ball game, yeah. And even Klippel too. Like, I mean, it seems like it's pretty much in hand. Like, what we talked about was how this bracket seems to be shaping up for him. Like, you don't want one of those guys going down now.
Beaver Dam led 21-7 with 7:15 left in the first half. They led 21-14 with about 15 seconds left in the first half and trailed 24-21 at the break. Hand off to Klippel again, and he is, especially, you know, playing on the turf.
Yeah.
You know, you never know.
Right.
And that'll move the chains with 2:50 left. You can hear some Slinger fans already saying take them out.
Yeah. Yeah.
Timeout taken by Beaver Dam.
Sounds like Randolph is driving. They've got it at the Krivitz 13 with 22 seconds left. Tried to punch one in to avoid that upset, a 7-2 game.
Tom Chase did a nice job with Randolph, a Hall of Fame coach. We were telling you, I talked to him, did a preview earlier in the week. I had a procedure done. I don't remember doing the interview. I went and got a procedure done, and I was like in the recovery room for not even 5 minutes, and they said, you can go. I'm like, what? and said, it's like Tuesday, and I'm like, when did I talk to Coach Chase?
So if you go back and listen to that pregame interview, you could,
which we heard on the kickoff show,
you hear what Wade sounds like when he's not quite with it.
38-21. We're popular people in here today, Coach.
Yeah, apparently.
You just keeping cell phones?
Yeah, I try to keep as many as I can.
38-21. Thede's going to throw again. They're throwing again, Coach.
What are they doing?
And they're throwing downfield and with 2:45 left.
What is
interesting.
I mean, if Thede's obviously limping too, even the fans over here from Slinger are like, what are you doing? Like, I don't.
Staying in the game.
Like, I don't.
Second and 10 at the 48.
You know, Beaver Dam, you might have a couple pass rushers have a little bit of extra juice off something like that, too.
It's 38-21 with 2:45 left, second and 10 from their own 45. They're going to motion Thede again, going to hand off on the jet, going around the near side to Mikanik. And Brock Lindy going to take a timeout. Little gamesmanship now, Coach, right?
Yeah, I mean, I guess I don't blame him. I mean, and so that starts on the slide, so he's only going to pick up three. Like, yeah, I don't – like I say, yeah, I mean, could have been very simple. Run the football, get your guys off the field. And I mean, you look at – I mean, you watch Thede walking back to the huddle. He's a very distinct limp. I mean, I feel like – I think we both feel like Slinger's got a real chance here to make a run.
Yeah.
He's a really good football team. You talk about, you know, their front, you know, seven or eight, and their offensive line, and their offense is impressive. I think the one thing we saw tonight out of them is, you know, if they play a team that can wing it around a little bit, their secondary is vulnerable.
.236 left. Mark D, who does a lot of, is wondering if they're close to some passing records, maybe.
Yeah, but I mean,
they're gonna get it next week. They just ran Lydell on the jet sweep too, Coach. Jeez. On third down. Brock's gonna take another timeout. Then he's gonna burn him.
I'm shocked. You guys got 10 catches tonight, and you're gonna run him on a jet sweep with 2:20 left. And it's a 3-score game. Hey, Lydell is so impressive. Like, they're not winning without him. I mean, he's really good. Hey, he's a very, very impressive player.
It's going to be fourth down with 2:29 left.
Randolph scores from 7 yards out with 12 seconds left to take a 34-33 lead over Krivitz.
All right. Coach Chase's squad again. He was up at Wyweega Fremont for a long time and then followed his son, I believe, to Ripon College and coached there while he was there. And then I always talk to him. He's driving home from Randolph whenever I get him on the line. Hey, they gave us a little Alabama at that last timeout. Adds to the playlist here.
Yeah, it's been really solid.
Fourth down and 7 from their own 49-yard line, and Slinger's going to punt. Short kick on the right side, and that's going to end up on the track. So the Beavers will have the football back with 2:22 left.
It's going to be with the 31.
They've still got most of their starters in there, Coach. Do they have some second guys? Yeah, no, they have some second unit guys in there now. Retzloff is still in there. Weston is still in there. Lytle is still in there.
Yeah,
Rodriguez is still in there.
Burkle
is still in there.
Yeah,
Mendoza is going to line up in the tailback slot. Going to hand off to Cameron. Cameron's going to bull over a few guys. Look at that.
There you go.
Cameron up to the 40-yard line. With the 2:15 left, it's 38-21. The Beavers going to rush to the line of scrimmage.
Pickup of 8 for Cameron.
Beavers got to get back to the line of scrimmage. Leo George hustling back to the far side. Hand off to Mendoza. Again, the Mendozer. Cameron through traffic and puts his head down across the 50 with under 2 minutes left.
I mean, I got to think this is Coach Lindy saying, you're going to keep those guys in there? You're going to need to tackle Cameron then.
Beavers now making some substitutions. They have enough guys on the field. The clock winding at 1:47. Snap the football. Bryant's going to throw. Here comes some pressure. Eli's going to throw it downfield, and it's going to be knocked around and deflected by Lydell over there with 1:37 left.
Good block by Josiah Barnes there on the defensive end that got around and given Eli time to make that throw.
38-21.
Second and 10 at the 49.
Keel, Mendoza, George wide to the left. To the near side, it's Freund. Second down and 10. Bryant going to throw to the right side, looking for Freund, who makes the catch and gets out of bounds at the 30-yard line with 1:31 left.
Put that at the...
Well, this one's going. Freund's maybe off the plane from the Cayman Islands by the time this thing's done. Wayne took care of his business down there. All right. Barnes is back there. Play fake. Mendoza is going to catch it on the right side, and he's going to step through one, breaks another tackle. Look at Cameron. Work his way down to the 20-yard line with 1:23 left. 1:18 and counting, 38-21.
Second catch for Mendoza on the night, 18 yards.
Bryant going to throw the screen on the far side, caught by Freud. He's going to stay in bounds. Jeffrey's going to get inside the 10 with 1 minute left.
That was Leo.
Was it Leo?
Yeah.
All right, Leo George. Better eyes than me, coach. We'll stop the clock with 1:03 left. Bryant going to throw right side. Here's Kyler Keel, who make the catch, and he'll step into the end zone with 51 seconds left, and it'll be a touchdown for the Golden Beavers.
And that is touchdown pass number 4 on the night for Eli Bryant.
What's the yardage on that, coach?
8 yards.
Final from earlier today, Germantown over Milwaukee King, 15-9.
Extra point pending. And it's up and good. 38-28. Back in 30 seconds on 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
Join the American Packaging team and help create packaging for some of the most iconic brands in the world. Sarah says the benefits at American Packaging are fantastic.
At American Packaging, we have a great 401k match. They match us 75 cents for every dollar up to 5%. And we get quarterly bonuses if we meet our budget. We get a Christmas bonus. If you've been here 5 years, you will also get a seniority bonus.
Learn more about joining the American Packaging team in Columbus and DeForest by checking out the careers page at AmericanPackaging.com.
Another 50 seconds left in this one, coach. 38-28. Beaver Dam cuts that lead to 10. I'm sure we'll expect the onside kick right here.
Yeah, nice drive. I mean, Beaver, you know, Eli Bryant, a couple nice throws, a couple nice plays by the receivers. Said Eli Bryant with his fourth touchdown pass of the night.
Mendoza's going to set up for the onside kick.
Little is Slinger not having guys up on the line. Now they're starting to creep up a little bit.
Mendoza. Little bouncer. They got a bounce. It's all over the place, and it's going to be picked up by Slinger at the 35-yard line, and that should probably do it.
Never know.
I'm not sure.
Shot deep yet.
Still got the starters in, coach.
Beaver Dam has no timeouts left.
Appreciate everybody dialing us in on Beaver Dam football this season. Working on the winter sports schedule, coach. Next week we'll probably have the rough shell of that out, including the 1430 ESPN Slam at the Dam. We'll talk about as we get closer. And that will almost do it as Thede takes the snap. And quarterbacks hate that, the rushing yards there.
Yep.
When he takes the knee.
Yep.
And one more snap from Slinger, and they will advance to host Germantown next week. And that's going to do it. Slinger rallies from 21-7 down in the first half to beat Beaver Dam 38-28. Coming back with the postgame show here on 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam and Daily Dodge TV.
Hi, this is Dr. Adam Forster at Columbus Family Dental. If you've been unhappy with your smile, it's time that you come and see us. Our team of doctors are waiting to help you get your smile back. We'll take the time to talk with you and treat you like a member of our family, not just another number. Whether it's a whole mouth makeover or simply a little tweak, we'll find the right solution that fits you. For your free, no-pressure consultation, call us today at 623-5559.
Cheer! Now cheer louder!
Any accomplishment worth doing is worth doing with all your heart and soul. The entire team at Hometown Glass and Improvement knows that dedication, time, and respect can lead to greatness. When practicing free throws, running for a touchdown, or installing new windows and doors, it's a commitment to something larger than oneself that creates a legacy. So keep cheering for your hometown team. Hometown Glass and Improvement, online at hometownglass.com.
Jerry's Automotive in Beaver Dam is a champion of our local schools. Team up with Jerry's Automotive by pumping your gas at their Spirit Pump, where 2 cents of every gallon is donated to a local school each month. Jerry's Automotive also provides exceptional vehicle service and repairs and a great selection of convenience items. Visit Jerry's Automotive Center, WI.com, and on Facebook. Jerry's Automotive, 700 North Spring Street in Beaver Dam, across the street from Beaver Dam Food Pride.
Join the American Packaging team and help create packaging for some of the most iconic brands in the world. Sarah says the benefits at American Packaging are fantastic.
At American Packaging, we have a great 401k match. They match us 75 cents for every dollar up to 5%. And we get quarterly bonuses if we meet our budget. We get a Christmas bonus. If you've been here 5 years, you will also get a seniority bonus.
Learn more about joining the American Packaging team in Columbus and DeForest by checking out the careers page at AmericanPackaging.com.
You're watching the Daily Dodge postgame show.
Back at Slinger High School, Wade Bates and Tim Ladron here. 38-28, Slinger rallies by Beaver Dam coach today, and we'll let you stay sitting down since you had your knee replaced. It's okay, and Beaver Dam came out, like I said, playing well, and Slinger just rallied in the second half, and that last 30 seconds of the half really was the difference maker, I think.
Yeah, you just feel like if that doesn't happen, what happens?
Yes.
Right? Just don't know. Like it. You got to be really proud of the effort of the boys. Really good night tonight. Really great season.
What do you have for numbers?
Slinger wins at 442 to 377 in total yardage. Michael Thede is 13 of 20 for 97 yards and a touchdown, but he also had 3 rushing touchdowns along with it. Mark Lytle, 10 catches for 168 and a touchdown. Caleb Burkle had 18 carries for 116 to lead him on the ground. For Beaver Dam, Eli Bryant, 16 of 35, 206, 4 touchdowns. Kyler Keel had 2 of those touchdowns, 8 catches for 102. Jeffrey Freund, 4 for 65 and a touchdown. Cameron Mendoza, 2 for 18. Leo George, 2 for 20 and a touchdown. Josiah Barnes led on the ground, 12 carries for 114.
Here's how the scoring went down in this one. Beaver Dam struck first, 109 left in the first quarter. Eli Bryant hit Kyler Keel in a 12-yard touchdown pass, 7-0. And that's how we ended the first quarter. In the second quarter, 9:40 left, Slinger struck back. Mike Thede, a 1-yard touchdown run on fourth and goal for the Owls. The extra point got hammered through, 7-7. But Beaver Dam had the answer. Bryant to George, an 8-yard touchdown pass, made it 14-7. Beavers then on a squib kick, recovered a couple of plays later. Bryant hits Freund. It's 21-7, Golden Beavers. Slinger, though, jumped right back. Jack Klipple. 8-yard touchdown run, 21-14 is where we sat. And it looked like Beavers were going to go into halftime with the lead. And what happened was Cole Martin hit one off the crossbar, coach, and made it 21-17 on a 38-yard field goal. Beavers took the kickoff, fumbled the kickoff, recovered by Slinger, and they threw a Hail Mary into the end zone. Lytle caught it, and all of a sudden, Slinger's up 24-21 at the half. Third quarter, Slinger goes on a 12-play, 83-yard drive, capped off by a Thede touchdown run, 31-21. That's where he went to the fourth quarter. 10:40 left in the fourth, and a 4th-and-3. Thede goes around the right side for a 20-yard score. 31 unanswered points for the Owls to lead 38-21. The Beavers only ran 6 plays in that time frame where Slinger scored a couple of times. 50 seconds left, Bryant to Keel for Beaver Dam. And that was the final, 38-28. Coach, but again, Beavers have to hold their head high because they made huge progress as a program. They competed in the Badger Large this year with, you know, pretty much the entire league and worked through a lot of adversity and you have to be proud of their effort this year, even though, you know, they're probably sad right now.
You know,
I would say, you know, as a support, as a teacher and a coach and basically a supporter of anything green and gold, I'm so proud of these guys. I'm so proud of the coaching staff. These guys have really, really put kind of Beaver Dam football back, you know, kind of on the map. You know, they've had a great year, get to a five seed, dealt with adversity all year, and we saw different opportunities throughout the year, especially late in the year, where they could have lost some games and not even been in the playoffs.
Yeah.
And really showed some mental toughness that got them over the hump when they needed to. You gotta be really, really proud of this group and the way they finished off this season.
And Coach, the way this team is set up, and you look at where the youth programs are at and where the lower levels are at, it's not one of those, hey, we had a 6-3 year and then we're gonna go back to 2-7 next year. They're set up to have success.
I think they are, and here's the thing too, like and you know, you brought this up before, and it's a great point. And I know you used to talk about this a lot. Listen, and I'm telling our athletes and our younger guys that are out there, the weight room matters. And if you don't understand it now, then you're never going to understand it. But this group has put so much time for 4 years into the weight room, and it's put them in a really good spot in athletically, not just in football but across the board. It matters. Get in there. It matters.
So Beaver Dam drops their game here, 38-28 here. So, Tim, for me and you, again, this is going to be our last football broadcast of the year. You know, I appreciate all you've done. You worked through some knee surgery as well and made it up here down the stretch. It's been a fun season for Golden Beaver football.
It really has, and thanks for having me again, Wade. And I love working with you. It's a great time, and I love supporting these guys. And just it's a really good season, and one that I think hopefully especially these seniors can remember.
You know, we like to have fun on the broadcast, not only deliver the play-by-play, but we like to have fun with the broadcast, you know, and make everybody a part of it. So we appreciate you being a part. Appreciate Justin Wilski again for being there every week for us as well. Does a great job. His daughter Ember kind of hauls equipment around, and Jack Wilski back at the station pushes the button. But, you know, Beaver Dam High School football was brought to you in part by White Construction, The Dump, Air Care, Jerry's Automotive, Preferred Dental Partners, the Park Village Shopping Center, Reed Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Richards Insurance, Surefire, Mayville Tire and Service, Beaver Dam Tire and Service, Summit Ford, Silica for Your Home, Slumberland, Klinowski Real Estate, McKinstry's Home Furnishings, American Packaging Corporation, Cousin Subs of Beaver Dam, and a Beaver Dam High School football is presented by Hometown Glass and Improvement, Columbus Family Dental, and the Beaver Dam Unified School District. We'll have football next week on Daily Dodge TV. Columbus is going to Prairie du Chien. I shouldn't say for sure. We have to figure that out because now there's some NFSH, National Federation of High School rules. Our plan is to be in Prairie du Chien next week for Columbus and Prairie du Chien. Mike and Tim will have that call. But, again, Beaver Dam, great season. 38-28. Football Friday night is coming up next. We'll join that in progress here. For Justin Wilski, for Jack Wilski, for Tim Ladron, my name is Wade Bates. Final score from Slinger, the Owls 38, Beaver Dam 28. You've been listening and watching to Beaver Dam High School football on Daily Dodge TV and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam. Have a great night, everybody.
You're watching the Daily Dodge postgame show.